Dells. Your boy Dells got nothing but love for you. That's why I'm live right now at 10:21 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, giving you a heads up right now. All of these shoes are available on the Restock. Some are releasing, I think, for the first time, these Bred Lows. I think this is the first time they hit the United States. I've seen them release outside the United States, but I don't think they've ever released here in the States. So right now, go in the description box below. That is linked for your convenience. Don't ever say Delzy don't love you, because look what I'm doing right now. I'm here to help you. Smash that thumbs up button. I'm going for those Chicagos, the UNC, the Chicagos. I missed out on those, and I've always been a little annoyed that I missed out on them. I seen that dude DS Kicks with them, I think yesterday or the other day. And I just was thinking to myself, I said, man, I still feel some sort of way. I never got my hands on that shoe. But yeah, good morning to everyone. Sneaker King is saying bots going crazy. Odd, Vinny says. Incog says, I'm here. He goes, oh yeah, baby, good morning. Thanks the universe for looking out for your boy. And then he writes, much love. That's what's up, Danny. What's up? I don't know what that means right there, but much love to you, girl. Joker Nation, what's up? And yeah, if everyone could just hit the thumbs up button so that you know, it works with the algorithm and all that, start recommending this more, get more people up in here. What links in the description, go in the description box. I have them. I took the time to literally put all the links and label them underneath the screen. So I got that for your convenience. So just go underneath it, look in the description box, and good luck. I hope you guys are able to score. Once again, I'm trying to get them. Oh, and also there's the biohack restock too, but I never have luck on that damn site. Jay Lou, what's up, fam? But yeah, man, just wanted to go live and just see if anyone was able to get anything. I'm right now trying. That's why I'm not showing face right now, because I just don't feel like, you know, looking like crazy with my eyes all over the place, trying to go from window to window, trying to see if I got in. Slim says he just got in, which I love to hear, man. I hope you're able to buy your pair. Let me know what sneaker you're looking for. Once again, with me personally, I want to get either the Red Satins or the NC to Chicago's. So those are the ones I'm going for. And hopefully I have some luck. If I can help you guys have some luck, then I'll be happy, though, at the end of the day. And I think that some of you, it looks like some of you will be able to get that luck. It looks like some of you actually scored. Oh, his payment went through. See, I can't even get on there. I have this waiting screen, which sucks. So when you have that waiting screen, what do you guys do? Do you guys refresh, or do you just keep waiting? Or do you open up a window and just open multiple windows? Let me know your strategy. Do you just hold off and you just click on the link and you stay on one actual page? Or do you just keep clicking the link and open multiple windows? Let me know how you score your sneakers. Look in the description box, bro. I have everything. I put extra time to organize it. All the sneakers with all the links to help you out. So just go in the description underneath the screen, and everything is there for your convenience. But yeah, give me some intel of what you're doing, how you're getting it going with these. Oh, wait a minute. I think I'm in there. Oh, it says sold out, I think. Oh, no, wait a minute. I may be all right. I'm going for these Bred Lows, but the page is a little weird. Did I get in? Yo, stop playing with my emotions. I got in on the Bred Lows, and then all of a sudden, it takes me out. Mother effer. I mean, come on. Yeah, I want to get these too. I'm very interested in these. I finally get in, and then it does me dirty. They also have these mids, guys, too. If you're looking for these mids, check them out. Shinsei, what's up, fam? He says, watching before work today. I am stuck on the webpage on Finish Line. Yes, me too, bro. Link in the description. I have them all organized for your convenience, Ricky. Just look underneath the screen in the description, my friend. My friend Shinsei, he says that he's going for the 11 lows and the UNC to Chicago's. Yeah, I like the 11 lows, but I'm not the craziest fan of lows with 11s. I have enough of them in my stash, so I'm going to chill. So what I am going for is I'm going for the New York to Chicago's, the Bred lows, and I'm also going for the Satins. I like the Satins. I think the Satins is a pretty dope pair of kicks. So that's what we're doing right here. Don't forget, we have Super Chat and Cash App. My Cash App is Real DJ Dells. It's on the screen. Cash App is the money sign in the comment, in the chat. If you'd like to send a buck or two, it definitely is much appreciated. I'm doing this YouTube full time, so you know, so show some love. Also, I have in the description, some of you guys may just be looking for a new pair of kicks, something to beat around. These shoes are on sale for $44. $44 ships worldwide also. These are dope, man. I've had these before. And for $44, why the hell not? So that's also linked in the description box. The extra discount will come off automatic in cart. So if you're looking for them, that's also in the description. And we also have my Sneaker Addict t-shirts, of course. So check out the t-shirts. They're all really dope. And you'll get you'll get so many compliments on my t-shirts. So many, guys. So let's get back to here. Enough with the this, that, and the third. How are we doing with everything? How are we doing? Wait a minute. Which one is this? Oh, the laser? Let's try getting these lasers. And, well, you know, when I get into the main screen, it looks really strange. Like, it doesn't even show the image. It just has a bunch of black hearts. Are you guys seeing this? It has a bunch of black hearts. Let me show you really quickly what I'm talking about. Let me see. Let me get this out. Wait a minute. Yeah, you see, it's got black hearts. Isn't that weird? What the hell is that all about, right? I don't understand what that's all about. Is anyone else seeing that? What's the deal with that? Hey, Victor, another Patreon member. We got Shinsei in here. We got Victor in here. Shout out to the whole Patreon fam. He says, hey, Dells, no, not through Finish Line. Placing orders, no email confirmation. I later find out it was canceled. Shit. What's up, Bay Area? Shout out to Juan. Big Perm is in the building. What's up, girl? You need me? Okay. Big Perm. What I missed? There's a restock right now, dude. I have a bunch of the shoes that you're going to want linked in the description box, so check it all out. And I just wanted to go live in the morning just to try to look out and try to help you all out, you know what I mean? Because it's so hard to buy Jordans lately, right? So I found out about this restock, and I'm just streaming from my phone right now while I'm trying to buy them. That's why you're not seeing my beautiful face that I know so many want to see right now. But in case, instead, you're just going to have to look at this. I'm sorry. I apologize. I know my beauty is just amazing, but you're just going to have to deal with it today. But yeah, as I said, just trying to help you all out. And I hope that I have. It looks like I have helped some of you. So that's a great thing. If you're watching on the replay, it's very important that you turn the notification on. Link in the description, Holly Hood Fly. Link in the description to all the shoes. All of the shoes. I put some extra time to break them all down for you. So look in the description. And yeah, man, my computer is tweaking, or the site's tweaking. But things ain't looking good for me. How we doing? What we copping? What we getting right here? Mo Kick says, what's good? Finish Line is trash. Thanks for reminding us of the biohacks at the mall. I'm lucky enough to get two more pairs. Did you get me a size 9 since I helped you out? Are you going to help me out? Oh, you just got the UNC, the Chicago's. Good, bro. I can't get on the site. It's driving me mad, bro. Because that's the one I really want. I'm not hating on you. I love that you got it. You know you my guy, bro. But I just can't even get on this. Oh, wait, I got on the site. Oh, God. Come on. Now it's not showing me sizes. You're going to do me like that now. It's not showing me any sizes. Stop playing with my emotions. You suck, dude. This site sucks, man. I mean, the drizzling shit. I know, Nino. Tell him, Nino. You're mad, too. I know, Nino. You hear my door. Oh, wait. I got in cart. Oh, my goodness. We may be hitting something. Holy moly. We may have something, boys and girls, ladies and gents, winners and losers, dirtbags and scumbags. Your boy Dells is about to check out. It's looking like. Oh, my goodness. Sensei, you may have rubbed off some of that luck on me. You may have rubbed off some of that luck on me. Okay, come on. My son's attacking me now. He's trying to wrestle with me, put me in the sleeper hold. It's things are going crazy over here right now. Oh, did I get it? Oh, we got it. We got it, Maddox. We got it. Let's celebrate. Let's celebrate together. We celebrate together. We got it. We got it. We got it. Am I on camera? Why can't I get on camera? Look, we'll celebrate together. We got it. See, I'm getting attacked by this child right here. That's why I got to be off cam. This kid is attacking me. All right, so we got one W today, and I really wanted those. Oh, I'm so happy. As I said, I seen the guy DS Kicks showing his pair, and I said to myself, oh, my gosh. Gosh, I need these, man. So beautiful thing. Beautiful thing. I got a 10.5. I feel like I should have gotten a 10. I know everyone says to go up a size and a half, but yeah, these things are so dope in person, I think. Yeah, so we caught that W, man. Thumbs up for the W. Yay! DJ Dells finally bought it. You got a pair. If they don't cancel my order. If they cancel, they can't. Let's go for the red satins now or the lows. Yeah, my son is just like, he's the best. But in the morning, he just wants to like, just like put me in the chokehold all the time. He's absolutely out of his mind. All right, let's go for these, baby boy. He's my good luck charm, I guess. Oh, look. Huh. We may be getting, oh, wait a minute. It's saying $32 for shipping? That ain't smelling right. Why is it saying that? We ain't doing that. That's crazy. Oh, maybe I have to log in. Is that why? Oh, I'm not logged in, so I didn't get my points and all that jazz. God, come on, bro. You can't be serious. Ah. That's probably why. How are you gonna, why are they asking? These just, I'll show you a picture, bro, of everything that came out. It's most of the stuff that came out. I have it all linked in the description box. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up button for everyone that's walking in right now. Shout out to everyone. I'm trying to remove that hit the money and do the cash app because it's blocking the other shoes. Let me get that shit out of here. Okay, now you can see. Yeah, these are some of the shoes that released. I don't know why it asked me to. That shipping's crazy. $32? That ain't right. Oh, no. Now it's saying free. These guys are crazy. All right. We're going to try to get those bread ones. Oh, now they're doing me dirty. I see. Yeah. Oh, you want Baba? Come on. We got to get you Baba. Forget about these shoes. Come here, you little weasel. Come here. All right, I got to take a timeout from trying to get those. Let's go on camera. We'll go on camera, boy. Say hi to the people. Say hi to the people. There's my crazy son. Oh, man. But yeah, man, I had to go live. I had to see what's up. Let me get me off of this. I'm being shy today. I'm being shy today. What are you doing, boy? We got some new J's. You got plenty of J's. You got more sneakers than me. All right, let's get you a bottle, kid. So what we getting, guys? Talk to me. This chat seemed kind of quiet. What the hell? Can we get some dialogue? What are you trying to buy? I want to know what you're trying to buy. My son wants to know what you're trying to buy. You know, you want to know what are you trying to cop, man? Yeah, that's right. Tell him, boy. We trying to know what you trying to cop today, guys. Let us know. What you guys getting? The OG. Is this US only? I think so. Yeah, no, it was a mess up. Mess up. I think that site is just getting rammed up the cornhole with no lube. So, you know, it's just not working. Here you go, baby boy. Here, let me get you some cereal too, kiddo. Yeah, I think that site is just getting smashed. So it's all messed up right now. Tops World, I'm buying a Lambo right now. Tops World is getting lots of money, bro. Watch out for Tops World. He's gonna be doing the raffles for the Lambo soon. He's getting a Lambo to do a raffle on. It's gonna be a million slots at $15 a person. So be on the lookout for that million. It's gonna be crazy. Biohacks, link in the description. Links in description box, guys. Look in the description. What's going on, my brother? What's going on with you? That's the question. What's going on? Yeah, Top's doing a raffle. Yo, someone should do that, man. Get a Lambo and do a raffle. Like you know, where it's mad affordable. We just have mad people just drop $10, $15. But, I mean, it's going to be like 500,000 people dropping, you know. Imagine how tiny those things would be. Hey, Joey. Joey knows candies up in here. I'm just kidding. Joey knows kicks. Ah, man. Come here, son. Yeah, I'm doing daddy daycare today. So I'm bouncing around. I'll cam up in a minute. We'll show up some sneakers. We get some love in here with the thumbs ups, more thumbs ups and all that kind of vibe. We're going to show some kicks. Yeah, man, we got to do that, man. The Lambo. They working. Everyone says they working but you, big dog, but you can try Finish Line. They are working though. I know that for a fact. That's a fact of life. Perm. My Air Jordan 3. Yo, you are you in these chlorophylls? You love them chlorophylls. This guy, I love him because he's always on my stream. So I say it with love. But he always talking about his chlorophylls, how much you like them. But that's great, man. When you constantly talking about something you love, like a pair of sneakers you cop, that's fire. I love that. I think that's fresh, man. So, salute. Salute for you liking it. Gucci! Oh, man. So, what are we doing, guys? What are we buying? Tell me. What you buying, bro? What you copping, bro? Out of these four sneakers, what's the order? 1 through 4. What's the order? What's the number one stunner, and what's the your least favorite as number four? Let me know in the comments and in the chat. Which one of these is the number one stunner? Curious to hear your thoughts on that. I'm gonna go with the here. Yeah, boy. It's okay. 11s for sure. I'm gonna go with the Jordan 1. I'm a little unsure which one I like better. But it's gonna be one of them Jordan 1 highs. I'll probably go with the I don't know. I like the UN to Chicago. Remind me of them Nintendo a little bit, the new Nintendo joint. The Switch. Got that Switch vibe. But I do like the women's satin snakeskin joints. They're really nice. I think that people slept on those a little bit, just a little bit. I'm actually trying to add it to cart now, the satins. What the? Yo, is Finish Line really trolling us today? Like, just mad sneakers. Like, it's a lot of sneakers that released today. Like, not a little bit, a whole lot. I mean, are you guys hitting on these? Are you trying to buy? Are you not trying to buy? Talk to me. I'm curious to know. Oh, now they fucking with me. Oh, wait a minute. Now they fucking with me. I gotta stop swearing. What am I doing? I feel like I'm on my Patreon podcast where I just swearing like crazy. I gotta chill. All right, what the heck is going on here? Let's see what's up with this chat. They refunded my money for the Satins. Ah, that sucks. Oh, this guy, I think it's Christmas right here. 91.4 kicks. He buying everything out. He he's saying which ones he likes better. Excuse me, I forgot that question earlier. I'm bugging. He says the Satin, the UNC, the Chicago's, the Lowe's, and then the Concord's. All right, I'm not mad. I think that's where I'm at too, bro. I think that's where I'm at. I actually would prefer those Lowe's of the ones versus the 11s. They just, I don't know, man. When I see the 11, I just want it in its purest form, you know? Oh, yeah, that site is getting smashed. Let's see what else we got. I've got 1 and 3. Okay. Perm, LOL. I'm not trying. I got through before, but no confirmation. Got through at all bum-ass waiting page. It's good. Yeah, that waiting page is the worst. Joker King says UNC, the Chicago's, then the Satins, then the Concord Lows, and then the Bred Lows. Okay. All right. I think people are basically running with the ones right now. And then, you know, after that, we go, it's a battle of the Low and the Concords. It's looking like that's really what it comes down to. Which one do you like better, the Concord Low or the Jordan 11, Jordan 1 Low, excuse me. Shinsei says, you NC to Chicago's numero uno. And then 11 Low, Satins, and then the Jordan Low. Okay. Then, let's see. I add the UNC to Chicago and bag, but just loaded forever now. Yeah, that's what happened to me, dude. Same shit with me, man. So I'm sitting here trying to see what I can make happen. I mean, I'm happy. I really wanted those. I think they're so dope. So I'm just very happy that I was able to get those. The Jordan Bred Low, I'm just copping off the strength because I know some of y'all are going to want to watch that review. And why the hell not? And I may like them better in person. They're cool. But I don't know 100% how I feel. I got to see these in person. I got to see them in person. I think we got them. I think I just got the Lowe's. Oh, I'm going ham today. I'm just copping all types of shit. What's going on with Delzy here? Delzy's wilding. And I'm talking about myself in the third person. Yes, I know it's weird. But whatever, I'm weird. You guys are getting to know this as you get the stream. Get this stream like this, man. I think I just got them. Yep. Okay, bong bong. So we just got two pairs. Wow, we just going ham cam right now. Okay. All right, Delzy. So we got the Bred Lows coming. And on top of the Bred Lows coming, we got the Jordan UNC to Chicago's. The UNC to Chicago 1, when did that release? Did that release last year or this year? Refresh my memory. Was that this year's All-Star sneaker with the red? Didn't that come out with the red threes and all them other kicks? Refresh my memory, please. Amen to that, brother. I feel you. I mean, if you're just going to be... we don't even need to go there. It's just whatever. That made... Let's see. Yeah, so if you can answer that question for me. When did those New York City Chicago's come out? Was it this year or last year? I'm done with Finish Line. They're trying to take all my money. But I hope they don't kill my emotions and then, you know, tell me that my stuff is canceled. I can smell it a mile away. I'm going to get that email and it's going to say, sorry, you know, we have to cancel your order. You suck ass. You know, they're just going to tell me that. And that's going to suck. By the way, tomorrow, if you're not subscribed to the Dell Show, tomorrow we'll be interviewing Chris Van Vliet. He's won, I think, 6 Emmys. He's interviewed The Rock, Dwayne Johnson, Will Ferrell, to every Hollywood superstar on the red carpet. I'm going to be digging into his brain tomorrow and trying to just learn how to be successful at interviews, at being a journalist and an interviewer. I probably will never even get close to that because I can't even speak proper English, but that's fine. Neither can any of you dumbasses that are watching right now. I'm just kidding. But yeah, so this is going to be a fun interview. We're going to hear about his story. Because he's so successful. I mean, and now he's even doing stuff like he's interviewing pro wrestling just because he's got such a love for it. So he's interviewing wrestlers. I've met him before. I've worked with him in the past. He's a fantastic guy. And if you want to learn more about the industry, this is going to be a great watch. So it's going to be tomorrow live at the Dell's Show on YouTube. So go over there. Check out the Dell's Show on YouTube. We do tons of interviews. We get all types of people. We interviewed Shelly Martinez a couple of days ago. Some of you guys were up in there having fun with that. So check that interview out. We have tons of interviews there. So go there. What do you guys think of this shoe real quick? I'm going to cam up in a minute. We'll show some sneakers since there's still a good enough. There's a good amount of you all here. How do you feel about these shoes? Just a quick question. I personally really dig them. I think this is going to be a big, big deal when these release. It's going to be a big, big deal. But I want to know how you all feel. Oh, and yesterday we did a funny video on... we did a really funny video on the Travis Scott's yesterday, by the way. The Travis Scott McDonald's situation. We're not going to call it a collaboration. We'll call it a situation because that's what it is. I mean, it's really not a collaboration. It's just a marketing thing. He says, oh, Shelly. Yeah, check out that vid. You'll enjoy that. You definitely will. Yeah, I think these are fresh too, bro. I think so. Joker Nation says fire. What are you doing? What am I doing? I'm on here talking to all of you and running around the house like a madman because I got all my kids home and I'm here watching them. I got two of my kids doing schoolwork. Here, baby boy. And then I have my two-year-old raising hell right now in the crib. So that's what I'm doing. What are you doing? You're watching me. That's what you do. Let's see. He says too much red for him. Okay. It is a lot of red. It's looking also like, guys, people are still buying all of these shoes that restock today. Like, people are still copping them. So make sure to cop them if you want them. You know, if you don't want them, then shit. Is any of you guys buying these to resell too? Admit it. Are you buying these to flip? I respect when people keep it 100. I didn't check. I haven't checked my email because I'm just walking around the house right now. I'll check my email real quick for you guys. I'll see. Nothing popped up on my phone, but I'll see. Holy shit. Okay. I just got some really good in the email. It looks like I had this big collaboration that I signed with, and it was on hold because of COVID. It's about to go back on. So that's very good news, guys. You'll see some of the, some of you guys will see this collaboration. It's not sneaker related, but yeah, I didn't get any cancellation yet, guys. Nothing yet. So we're in good hands still, but I didn't log in. I just used PayPal. I just used the PayPal. I went straight to the PayPizzle. So we'll see if they cancel my shit or not. Let's see what's going on here. Y'all want to see some sneakers? He said finish line be on some bullshit. Y'all want to see sneakers? Let me know. Thumbs up the video and say, show some sneakers. And tell me what sneakers you want to see. Tell me what sneakers you'd like me to show you. Check my bank app, Dells. I'm on my phone right now, so I can't do all that. Because I'm streaming right now from my phone. This way I can just wander around the casa. They taking the purchase and sending it back. Let's see what we got over here. Let's see what we got over here. Let's go in the sneaker room. We'll go in the sneaker room for a little bit. I will say, put some coins in the meter if you want me to hang out longer. We'll stay here for a little bit. We do need some coins in the meter, though. All right, we are in the room, the collector's room, the crazy room. Any kind of sneaker you want to see, we'll see if we got it in this room. Show me something, Dells. Let's show you these. Let's go hot right off the bat. Let's go with some hot, right? Some hot with some hype. Can anyone guess what this is? I'll show you the tag. Show you the tag first. Can anyone guess what this is? Guess the shoe. Guess the shoe. Dell, show us some brands like Saucony, man. Get off that Nike shit, man. Show us them brands like Saucony and Asics. All right, I got you. That what you wrote there remind me of Redman's Tonight's the Night with Hurricane G, when she's like, cut off all that smooth shit, man. I don't know if you guys know what I'm talking about. You probably don't. I'm in my own world. Skunks, okay. Skunks. He thinks they're skunks. I don't know if you can see the colorway on there. But let me know if you know what this is. We're just going to show it because I think there's a lag. I think there's a lag on this stream. Okay, let's take that out. One, a two, a three. We have got the Cheech and Chongs. These are so dope. Never wore them. I never wore these. I should wear them. I don't know why I never did. I don't think I did. Maybe I did. Yeah, I have wore these. I have. I see a little sesame seed down there. I have wore these. Barely. But I have wore these. Oh, this shirt, by the way, I'm wearing is so fire today. Let me get this out. Let me see if I can back this up. So, oh, I can just do this. Look. Oh, look at that shirt. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That's a sick shirt. Yeah, this is. These are sick. I never burned. Underneath this layer, there's like a layer of like green. It's supposed to be like, you know, like a joint kind of. I never did that. I just didn't want to. I was like, nah. But these are sick. These shits are sick. Like crazy. These are so crazy. So crazy. So crazy. Shout out to everyone that's a Nike SB collector. If you're not, it's no big deal. I know some of you just started jumping on this Nike SB thing. It's cool to see people are finally understanding how dope they are. But, I mean, there's a lot of y'all that are just on the bandwagon now because the shit's worth money, right? Let's be honest. So you want something sockety-wise? I showed these the other day, but I really love these so much. I think. Whoops. These are really dope. Bong, 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 right? Here, these are dope, man. Here's some Sacanese. This was a nice collaboration right here. Really nice collaboration. All right, I'm going to give you guys a 2-minute warning. All right, put some coins in the meter and we'll stay longer. If not, it was fun while it lasted. I'll see you guys later. Because I wasn't planning on streaming this long. Ugh. Here's another Saucony. Did you get the Chinatown Grateful Dead merch after everyone saw the LeBron on it? Not going to lie, I grabbed the shirt. Yeah, I'm not going to lie. I grabbed the hoodie. Because I'm hoping I can get the get those Crocs. I want those Crocs to match him. I like the fit. I thought it looked dope. You know, for some just to throw on and go out real quick, that'll be the fit. You know what I'm saying? Dope, bro. That's what's up. I got one pair of Sauconys left. Collab shoe. Cool, man. That's what's up, dude. These are the chocolate chip mints with the waffle cone paper. This era of New Balance, holy shit, of Saucony was this was legendary. They came out with so many great designs and collabs. Shout out to my boy Brandon who designed this, and thank you to Brandon for signing me on that collaboration too, because he's the guy who designed this actually signed me to do that collaboration. So shout out to Brandon, who ended up leaving Saucony and working with Kanye West. So, and now he's doing his own thing, which is super cool. Awesome dude. He says, I hate Crocs. I know they're not the most fashionable thing, but it got the whole Grateful Dead vibe. And I reached out to them. Hopefully they hit me back because they sent me these for free, like to review. So I'm hoping they'll hit me back and be like, yo, we got you on the size 9 of the Grateful Deads, you know? Because there's no way I'm going to be able to get the Grateful Dead sneakers, right? So, you know, shit. He says, I hate Crocs. That happened in 2011, not 2018. What are you talking about? I don't even know what you're talking about. Bro, who said they robbed stores? I don't even know what you're talking about right now. You must be talking to someone in the chat and not me. Because I don't know what the hell you're talking about. What are you? Does anyone know what he is talking about? Does anyone know what the hell this guy, this damn guy is talking about? That heel in the back of your foot, something terrible with Sauconys. Oh, yeah, I remember you saying that. Payne, what's up, Payne? What's going on, Payne? Shout out to Payne up in here. If anyone wants the cam up, by the way, show some sneakers off, please feel free. Or just talk sneakers, or just say hi. You could just use your phone. I'll throw that link in there.
Say hi.
Hi. What else we got here? Oh, shit. I'll show you something. These are, oh, I love these. Oh, I'm getting excited. Getting excited off of. Does anyone know what these are? What's wrong with you, bro? That's the million-dollar question. What you think of these? What do you think these are? Come on. If someone knows what these are, you cooler than a fan spinning above me right now. If you know what those are, I bet no one will know what those are. I bet you none of you will know what these are. Prove me wrong. Shut me up. Prove me wrong and shut me up. What are these? What are these? Someone will prove me wrong. I have faith in my following. And just because you don't know, don't mean that you're whack or corny. I'm just the sneaker addict, I guess, right? No one knows what these are. These are probably one of the illest pairs of ASICs on the effing planet. That's what they are. Okay? To me, one of the illest pairs of ASICs. The pistachios. Woo! Fire. Fire effects. Burning down the walls. I mean, let's get the CGI going. Come on. Come on, effects guy. Oh, we didn't pay him this week, so we don't got that. But yeah, man, this is a crazy pair of kicks. The pistachios. Yeah. Homeboy got the pistachios. These are sickening. Sickening. How sick are these? What you know about them pistachios? And they come with a plethora of laces. You got tons of laces here. Tons of goodies. These are so sick. To me, one of the best ASICs. Like, they killed it on this. Yo, the suede on these dog is like, you feel it. It's like, it's, you just want to do this to it. You just go to bed, man. Feels so good. I'm just going to go to sleep. Yeah, I feel good. Feels good. Let's see. What are we going to do next? You want non-Nike stuff? Oh, we got a guest up in here. We got Perm. Big Perm. What's up, guy?
Hang on. I'm a dunk guy, you know, and Jordan 1 and certain other Jordans, but I do have a Saucony, my last Saucony. I used to have a whole bunch, but I got rid of them just to random people or whatever. But I kept one that was, let's see if you know what it is. I'll reverse this game and see if you know what it is. It's just that regular box. I don't know if they have special box series.
Nah, that's the old, regular standard.
Yeah. So
let's get this thing out here. I don't got no clue what the hell those are, but they look nice.
Yeah, no. And Saucony always like...
It's Saucony, by the way.
Saucony. Saucony. I'm the West Coast. They say it's still like that.
Saucony, always. And yeah. They literally corrected me. You're saying it Saucony. Wrong. We love your passion, but you're saying it wrong.
What's the definition behind it? Is it somebody's last name or is it...
I have no clue. I never asked. I should have I was in HQ over there. But yeah, it's Saucony.
I just caught... I just call these the Saucony Bloods because of the inside.
What does it say, Billy?
It says Billy's. It's the 9000 grid. So I don't know. It's a collaboration that's a with something. Shoe. Yeah. Like low key, they always go go good with the materials. You know what I mean? Like underrated. Oh yeah, super
they
underrated.
Do. Their problem sometimes is the glue. The glue is sometimes the issue with them.
This
but that's
right
the
here.
Issue with everyone. The glue.
This right here, this toe box is like the Letterman jacket material, like a varsity jacket. That's what this is, and then this is a nice like a nice suede right there, and has the leathers, has a whole bunch of different materials on it.
I have a pretty cool pair that got that kind of varsity vibe. Yeah, I got it right here. And this was a gift they gave me. They gave me, the only people that got these shoes is me, Fomer Simpson, Hess Kicks, and a few other guys. And the only difference is they put, you know, our names on each one. When we were at HQ, Sneaker Shouts to my boy Ivan. You guys know Sneaker Shouts on Twitter, I'm sure. But yeah, we all got this. And this got like that leather. I don't think I've ever really shown these shoes off. It got that Letterman kind of material on the back end right here. And then this is reflective. The laces are reflective. It's got like this like super soft leather here. Suedes over here. And yeah, this was a nice gift they gave us. We were all sitting on a conference room. Think about like basically all the YouTube, a lot of YouTubers that you all know. We all just sat on this big conference table with the president of Saucony, and they handed us these bags. And this shoe was in the bag with some clothes and some other stuff. But yeah,
that's suede. Leather on that toe box looks nice, dude. That toe box looks nice.
Dog, the leather on this is crazy. I never wore these because it's so sentimental to me, you know?
Yeah.
Because and I also have a jacket that matches this. I think I may have sold the jacket. I'm not even gonna lie. I said, "Yo, I'm gonna sell the shit," because I didn't want to wear it because it fit too small. This is a sick pair of Sauconys too. This is the Dirty Martinis. This one is one of my faves from Saucony.
What is that? Is that like an infrared or a pink?
It's like an infrared. You know what? It's kind of like an infrared, the brightness of it, but it's like, you know, the olive with that red, what's that shit they put in the middle of the olive? Not the pitted.
The pimento.
Yeah, yeah. So this is supposed to be like a dirty martini, like the drink with the olive and drop in there. This color is supposed to represent that. And, It's a cool shoe. Like the suede is so like crazy on them.
Oh, you can see the brush already on it.
It's like, it's insane. Like, I mean, I've worn these so much. Like,
but now they look like they're holding up. They look like they're holding up.
Shit. Yeah, they are. I've taken a break on them because it's beginning to separate a little bit over here.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
And so. I don't know what to do, you know, but I don't want to get rid of them because. I like when I went to do my deal, I wore this shoe and another shoe the whole week. And I'm weird like that. I like to keep stuff like that. So when I look at them, it kind of just brings back some memories and shit. We'll show these just to show some hype shit real quick. We got to keep the hype in here. So
nice.
Yeah.
So. And you keep the rubber band on. Make sure you don't put that rubber band on it.
Oh, yeah.
The rubber, like if you store it with the rubber band, it supposedly leaves the ring around it.
I'm sure. Yeah, I haven't worn these yet. I'm gonna wear them though. I can't sell these because I got these as a gift, and I feel like that's bad energy when you do that. I'm as I said, I'm a little weird with shit like that. But a skate shop gave me those. I was like, "Yo, can you hook me up?" They're like, "We can't sell them to you, but we'll give them to you."
Even better. Like, okay.
I'm like, shit, man, you know. So that was a beautiful thing, man. Did you try to get any of these shoes at Restock today?
No, I have one of them already. The one right here. I have these ones.
Oh, give me one second. I just gotta grab some real quick. Pause. Which ones?
I have these ones already. So,
those. So I hope they don't cancel my order because I really wanted those.
Tell me, have you had the new pine greens? Have you seen the new pine greens?
I reviewed them at a store, but I don't own them.
So that, I mean, you, I don't know if you've seen these in hand either.
I reviewed those shoes.
To me, the side panels and the toe box, the material are kind of like the pine greens, but overall, I think this material overall. Like, as far if you wanted to do that, was better than the pine greens, like, overall. But, like, the toe box and the side panel, to me, reminds me of the pine green new ones. So,
yeah,
that's just me.
I walked into the store, and the manager let me film them, and they looked really, really good, man. They looked pretty damn good. I gave it a positive review, and I wanted them. I just, that day, I think that day my kids had like a basketball game, and like, you know, my kids come first for sneakers, so I wasn't able to.
Sure.
Yeah. So, someone asked me, my dude Payne, if you want to cam up too, please do, Payne. So this is the collab I did with Sock.
And dude, that is so freaking dope, bro. And I'm not just saying that too. There's just so many details. The bottom is my favorite part of that shoe right there.
Yeah.
That's iconic right there. That picture is iconic, bro.
It's iconic to the movie. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Like, I mean, in the kind of community that we're, the hip hop, you know, underground type community, that fucking is legend, bro.
And then the lining.
Like, yeah. The lining is
crazy. Yeah, this is the sample right here, as you can see. This was the retail. This was the last sample before it went to retail. One day I got to do a video to show you guys the other samples. Like, the original sample had like DJ Dells going down here. I was like, dude, I'm whoring myself out. I've got branding all over. The people know it's your sneaker. You have this image on the bottom. You know what I mean? I mean, it's even in the damn insole also. Like, I wanted to put out a shoe that was wearable, and that's why only suede on here, because I know white suede is hard to clean, so we kept it a leather on the top. It's a little weird, but wearable, you know what I'm saying? That's the major key. Sure. You can clean black suede. I mean, what's going to happen with black suede? You just clean it. It may not, you know what I mean? It's easy to, it's not like white suede. You get dirt on it, it's going to look like someone shit on your shoe after time, you know what I mean? So, the only problem with the shoe is, which I don't know, I kind of wish I made this black, because after time, this starts yellowing right here. This material here,
yellows. On the tongue? Oh, okay, gotcha.
Yeah, the neoprene, it yellows bad. And over here, it yellows bad, which is, I don't know what, this is like a neoprene material also. But really cool that I had the opportunity to. And I was planning on doing a reversal. I was even talking to my boy, the guy who actually got me signed on board. I wanted to do a reversal and have like this artwork somewhere on the shoe. Not overboard.
Yeah. But just like a subtle.
Yeah, just subtle. Like maybe on this part instead of the inside, and then maybe reverse that. I have a bunch of sketches I did for this shoe. And there was there was so many different ideas we were going to do. Thank you, JC Kicks. Dell's a legend. Shoot these youngsters, Dell's. I'll school these youngsters, Dell's. I'm reading shit crazy. No, we ain't shooting no one. Dude, thank you for the super chat, JC Kicks. Shout out to JC Kicks from your boy DJ Dell's. You always do what you're doing and win. That's what I'm telling you. You got to win, baby. But the blood splatter is supposed to represent when you know, that shower scene, you know, with the chainsaw, where they chainsaw his friend in the shower room. That's what the blood splatter really, because that scene and this scene, and then the scene at the end when Tony dies is like what really connected me to it all. And then when my dog became Yohan, I wanted to put the black and the white because, you know, I had to put some there with him, you know. So there's a lot of nods on this sneaker, which I like about it. Payne, got you, Payne. So I want these shoes to come back. I need to get rid of these shoes. I don't know why I still have them, but I need to get rid of them because they're falling apart. But I really like these right here. This is the Midnight Navy Jordan 1s, Jordan 6s, excuse me. They're falling apart. Like, it's literally falling apart. I was going to have someone fix these for me, but for what? But the leather, see, some people say to fix them because the leather is insane. Like, the leather on this is like leather you never felt before. Like, it's craziness. It's a damn what dinosaur knuckle, knee. It's out of control, man. But I may let these go, man. I may just sell these shits. I feel like I'm hoarding these. But you see, even on the, look, it's talking.
Yeah.
Perm. Hey, perm. You know, it's talking. So.
It's like, shoot me.
Yeah, yeah. Throw me away. Take me out of my effing misery. Here, I'll show you these two, guys. You guys want to see non-Jordans, So this shoe right here, this is a sample. Only 1,000 pairs. This is the Dub Rocker collaboration, it's got, you know, the Rasta vibes, the Jamaican colors right there. And only 100 pairs of these were made, and none were for sale. They were just to friends and family. The only person I know that I personally know that has these is Redman. So not many people have this shoe. I've seen them sell on eBay for about $2,000. So like this is, if you're like a big fan of Vans, like, you know, like this is a big deal, this shoe. If you don't know Vans
that's
well,
a Cali thing.
Yeah, if you
that's like, a Cali vibe.
Like Van collectors, this is like a grail. Like this is like, you know what I'm saying? This is a big deal. It's pretty cool that they sent me these. I seen them and I said, yo, I like these. Because I hit up, you know, these people, the Dub Rockies, and they were like, oh, we got you. You want them? We'll send you a pair. I'm like, all right.
What is that, like a, is that like a group or something, like a music group or something? Or is it just like
out, yeah, they put out music. Like they, you know, they got, they're like a DJ crew. Like they put out.
Yeah, reggae, dub is a style of reggae music.
Yeah, yeah.
Dub music, yeah.
Yeah, so, and they sent me like the vinyl to the new album they put out and a bunch of stuff. So it was dope, man. It was love that they sent it. Yeah, Finish Line got the Restock, guys. You may be a little late to the party on it, but hey, it's why the hell not try, right? I mean, why not try? You got GA Kicks in here. Add to the stream.
What's going on,
what's
y'all?
Up, GA?
Not much.
Today. That's good.
Big Perm, yeah. My God, what's popping, man?
What's
good. Popping?
What's good?
Not much. You know, it ain't that. I got this new dispatcher, Dells. So this dude asked me last week, right? When's the next time you want to be off, right? This is the second time, bro, this happened. I was like, all right, I want to be off next Friday, right? Mm-hmm. I was like, all right, cool. He's like, all right, cool. So I called. I was off yesterday, and I was off. I called this morning because usually you're off on Wednesdays. I called this morning. This man was like, oh, you want to be off Friday, right? I was like, dude, so you're going to have me off today again and mess my whole schedule up? So I was going to basically be off again yesterday, today. Then I still got to be off on Friday, so I'm going to be off 3 days. Mess my whole schedule up, my paycheck up, man.
Damn, that's terrible, dude.
He's new, but goodness gracious, you can't ask your driver when you want to be off. And then you messed up the schedule of him being off. And then Friday hits and he's going to call me. Oh, you got a load today. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Oh, a word? Oh, okay.
It looks like it's going to rain out these ways. So that may be good. Unless you don't give a shit about that.
I don't mind the rain. I just mind it when it's snowing, man. Because these folks can't drive in the snow down here, man. These folks will drive like...
Yo, people out around this way suck at driving, bro. No offense, man. I mean, but I drive in a whole other way. When you're a New Yorker, you have like this crazy, insane way of driving. It's very
I learned that.
And very
super aggressive.
My wife don't even like me driving. She's like, I'll drive.
But the thing is, though, Perm down here in Atlanta, like, they have so much accidents in New York. When I used to work in New York for my old trucking company, especially beyond the 95, they hardly had any accidents, bro. It's just traffic. That's it. Only saw like one accident.
Maybe little fender benders and shit.
Unfortunately, it was a truck with a whole nother, you know, regular civilian. I was like, damn, I know he getting sued.
Hey, I got another pair of shoes you've probably never seen.
I love the glasses, bro. What is that? Let me see.
Taking us back. Throwback.
Abdul-Jabbar. Abdul-Jabbar, look, Blueprint. It's made out of Blueprint, guys. This is Blueprint paper. And it came with these goggles.
That's insane.
See, it got his name on the back.
That's insane. That's what's up.
I thought you were going into wrestler vibes right there, goggled up for the rain.
How crazy honestly, is that, dog? They sent me this. It came with the goggles. I have a video on these. I literally have PJ, my dog, wearing these goggles. It's pretty effing funny, man. But yeah, I found these in my garage because I'm trying to rearrange my garage. I was like, oh my God, these are crazy. Yeah, it's Blueprint. Can you see through on the camera well or?
No, I just thought it was like a blue treated kind of leather. I mean, I don't know. How does it fit?
Let me drop you guys out so I can show the people really quickly. Like, and I'll
it almost looks like marble.
Oh no, I can't do that. I don't know how to do that on my phone. Yeah, it's paper. Maybe I'll reshoot this video real quick. This a review. I'll do a throwback on these one of these days. If you guys want that throwback, hit the thumbs up and leave a comment. Come back.
Throwback Thursday. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Review those damn blueprints. I mean, a blueprint is paper and suede, this shoe. It's crazy.
That's dope.
Yeah, paper and suede? That's insane.
Facts.
I'm never going to SneakerCon again. I don't support SneakerCon. I don't like SneakerCon. Sorry.
What about sneaker events?
Maybe a sneaker event, but not SneakerCon.
Yeah, just specifically not SneakerCon, yeah.
But never say never. Because you know what? It's a gift and a curse. I don't like SneakerCon, but I like y'all. So it's like,
yeah,
a bunch of people are like, yo, I want to see you at SneakerCon, then I may come through. Last time I was at SneakerCon, I seen Zaya X there. I've seen Mayer there. I seen Tony and Bull. And I pranked Tony and Bull. I got them scared, man. I got it all on video. I never released it. I got a bag of flour and I told them that it was cocaine. And I said, watch my bag real quick, right? So I put the bag behind them and then I forgot what I did. I think I texted one of them. I was like, yo, I go in my bag. There's a brown bag. I go, don't look what's in the bag. All right. I go, this guy's gonna come to your table and he's gonna take this bag, okay? He's gonna hand you a little bit of money. All right, just give him the bag. So it was something like that. I'm paraphrasing. It was a long time ago. So I had the bag open. So as soon as they opened the bag, there was no brown bag. It was just a bag of, it looked like cocaine. You know what I mean? So I was filming from far away and I was catching all their faces. They were shook. They were nervous. I mean, who wouldn't? You'd be like, what the hell is going on here? I'm not like dissing them like they're shook because of that. But it was mad funny. Because like they were uncomfortable, you know, and then I had my dude go over there and ask for the stuff, and then I walked out.
You had the middleman a deal for me. What are the fall guys? The fall guys.
They were nervous, though, bro.
That's fucking laughs.
Yeah,
that's
laughs. And that day they were acting real weird. That day they were starting to act a little brand new. So that was one reason why. If you watch that that video of the that infamous video, apologize to me. Like, there's a lot of stuff you guys don't know that was personal. They were acting funny and shady toward me. So just to put that out there. I don't want to talk about it no more. But
yeah, that's before my time. But, like, I'm a big person in time heals all wounds. You know what I mean? You know, there's just specific fucking things that are unforgivable. And those are, like, crazy whatever crimes. But – yeah. If it's petty stuff, dude, time heals all wounds.
No, you know
what I mean? We grow old. You know what I mean? We grow older, and it's like you're still holding a grudge from 7, 10 years ago. Like, you must be a real person. You know what I mean? Like, we can move on, you know? So, I mean, you know, but yeah.
When you're right, you're right. I'm not going
to. I mean, even best, like, one of my best friends in the world, like, we hated each other for, like, I think our whole, like, third grade year. We fought all the time. Now he's my best friend. I'd do anything for him. He's my best friend in the world. You know what I mean? So just shit like that. So
Perm sonning me on my damn channel. That's all good.
No, it's all good. No, never.
I'm kidding.
Never.
I'm cracking jokes, bro.
You could go to my channel. Name. You could go to my channel and troll me. Be like, don't believe this guy. He fucking cops himself.
No problem. That's real talk, though, bro. When you speak facts, you can't disagree with facts. If you disagree with facts, you're an idiot, and I'm not an idiot.
So not to be on a tyrant or anything like that, but, like, people don't like me because I repeat their words, and I'm like, this is how you sound. Like, I don't make stuff up about people. I'll just repeat what you said and be like, well, how does that sound? Like, this is what you're doing, and then they don't like it when you call people on their shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But like, no, I'm gonna do it in front of you, and I'm gonna do it on a camera. I'm gonna do it on the phone. We come from a different era where it's more in your face. Me and you, we're about the same age, and it's like it's in your face. It's like I'm gonna say it. If I get my ass whooped, I get my ass whooped. It is what it is. You know what I mean?
Oh,
like,
yeah.
I'm gonna move on. You know, so I don't know. A lot of
and sometimes speaking. Perfect example. So I'm at that SneakerCon. Me and Isaiah had it wasn't beef, but there were some things that were said, and, you know, there was a little bit of a situation. As I said, wasn't beef or anything, but it was like, I was basically like, yo, fuck Zaya, right? So I seen Zaya there, approached him, not on some like let's fight thing, but I approached him. We spoke like men, and I told him how I feel, and he spoke back to me about it and all that. You know what I mean? And now me and Zay are cool. You know what I'm saying? Like it's, sometimes it just takes dialogue. But a lot of people on YouTube, they'll talk crap and then they won't egos. They won't talk in person. You know what I mean?
It's egos. I don't have an ego. Yeah. I don't have an ego. Yeah. I can put my pride to the side for the sake of whatever. You know what I mean? So, but I mean, I'm still not. Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know. People just have too big of egos. You know?
Yeah, because so. With me, like I'll talk to anyone. You know, I don't fear anyone but God. You know what I mean? So, like, I'll talk to anyone. Will I mess with you? I don't know about that. Not you particularly, but you know.
Yeah, yeah.
But I'll talk to anyone.
There we go.
Yeah, for sure.
My bad about that, yo. Sorry about that.
What you got? Oh, take a shit, bro? You dropped the deuce?
No, mom's call.
You sure? Yeah. You drop a number three? What you do?
Nah, as long as you wash your hands. As long as you wash your hands.
Yeah, wash and your hands. Did you wear a mask while you pooped or no? You gotta wear a mask, bro. It helps.
You can only use my wife's in the medical field, and you can only use hand sanitizer so many times before you actually wash your hands. So there's only so many times you can use that in a day before you actually have to wash your hands. You know what I mean? You can't just go through the day hand sanitizer, I'm good. You actually have to wash your hands.
That's true. It doesn't make sense. I'm done with y'all today. I'm done with y'all for the day. Y'all got jokes, man. Y'all got jokes.
Oh, man. They still haven't canceled my order yet on those sneakers I bought. We'll see.
Check your spam email.
I'm already ready for the worst, right? Right. I mean, that's the best way to prepare when you're buying these restocks. And Finish Line is infamous for canceling orders. With me, they've done it many times. Finish Line and Sneakers have.
You just hit a Finish Line this morning. There was nothing on Shoe Palace or anything. I know Shoe Palace is kind of janky.
Shoe Palace, you know, they have these restocks all the time, but I never am able to hit on them. It's like, I almost feel like they're fake restocks. Does anyone actually land on these, not Finish Line, on Shoe Palace? Yeah. Does anyone actually land on Shoe Palace restocks?
People that I know don't. It might just be something to get you to the site, and then you buy something else. Yeah,
bait. They try to fish you in, and then you end up buying something else later on that day, right? Because, they had the restock today on the biohacks and the GS sizes of the Japan joints, the silver ones. Yeah.
In 2020, you never know. Somebody might tell somebody who has a box and the restock may have been
the
like,
bots are coming. Black games coming.
That's how these restocks work, unfortunately. Now, you see, that's why it's getting annoying, because there should be a time where restocks, at least a normal individual, right? Like myself. Perm or you could pick something up, but then if you don't get it at that time, like Sneakers Still, I always tell anybody on IG that Instagram, follow Sneakers Still, because those would be the place that will tell you instantly like when a restock is, but you have to be right there and then
you got to be at the party at the right time.
Yeah, like you're not this, you know what I mean? I'm gonna get it in about 2 hours. Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll be gone. All right,
Duel of the Iron Mike. That just made me think of Wu-Tang, Duel of the Iron Mike. Yo, let me show you some. I posted on Twitter today. I think I uploaded it on this thing right here. I have all these shoes still, but they're in my storage. But I like this photo because it just it's got some cool shit on there. Look at that. If you're a fan of Wu-Tang, Ghostface Killer Adidas. Mm. On the right, then you have the Saucony collaboration with Just Blaze, inspired by the Polo Snow. What the hell is the I forgot what the jacket was called, but it's an iconic jacket. Raekwon wore it in the Rain. I forgot what music video. Oh, Can It Be Also Simple? He wore that there. And then you got the purple tape joints. And then you have the purple tape, actually, which is pretty crazy. So there's some more sneakers that aren't. You know, things you don't see every day. Let's see what we got here. Sneakers had zero restocks for today's release. Sneakers doesn't really have restocks, though, do they?
Not really. It's More like Foot Locker now.
Just their drops. They just have their regular drops, but sneakers is broken.
Okay, sneakers I ain't lying. Broken, he just bought the UNC, the Chicago's in the size 10. Mm. So, you know, people are still winning out here. We're still catching W's. Thank you. Yes, Snow Beach. Yeah, Snow Beach joints. Shout out to Just Blaze, man. He designed those. Great dude, Just Blaze.
Mm-hmm.
And he watches the show, so if he's watching, shout out to you for real. We need you on the show, Just Blaze, because I know he watches. We need you. We need Currency. We need Wale. You all watch.
Doesn't he have a huge? He has a huge sneaker collection. Didn't like some drama happen with his collection a while ago?
Something
back in the day, or a few years ago.
Something
apartments or something
in his apartment. Yeah,
he had a whole bunch of rare shoes stolen or some shit. That's what I thought it was. It's like inside job type deal.
Oh, somebody, yeah, of course.
Inside job.
That's always been.
It always is. When it's theft, it's always an inside job. That's why if someone ever comes in here, well, if someone ever comes in here, they'll probably be spending their last times on
overwhelmed.
Earth.
Overwhelmed. They'll be overwhelmed. They won't know what to take. They'll just be like, what the fuck do I take?
I'll tell you, though, my security system is incredible. Like, I've got lasers that come out of the sky. They'll cut your head off with the lasers. Like, it's like Austin Powers movie. Like
a shark? You got a shark pit?
Oh, yeah, I do. I do, for real. Like, there's literally in my closet over here, this robotic arm just comes and it just yokes you up, and then it'll smash you into the lower area where we do have
a
shark tank.
You got a moat around your house?
In 20 seconds. So, yeah. Unless I get you, then you'll just have a billion holes all over yourself. But yeah, so let's get into this real quick. This super chat. It says, what do I think about the Oregon 5s? I like them. I've seen a review. I think B Lit did a review. Shout out to B Lizzie. And, he's not in here, but I know he'll be watching. And they look better seeing the reviews. But I just put the Oregon branding on there. Give me a duck. Quack, quack. You know, like we've seen it in the past. What you
say? It just has that patch, huh? It just has that patch on it.
Yeah, that's
just
that patch in the back. Seen on them Michigan joints.
Just give me what the fives and I'm done for the day, man. I got too many green shoes. I got these bad boys. So I'm already done with the green shoes.
Oh, yeah,
thing,
you greened out. You can't get more green than
man.
That.
Yeah. Let me get the what the fives. And
I just got I just got these green shoes. I don't need another green shoe. Like,
those are nice.
I mean, how many people got more than two or three pairs of green shoes in their arsenal? Do you, Perm?
I think this might be the only green shoe that I have. But it's not fully.
Oh, that's a beauty. That's a beauty. That's a beauty right there.
That's the Brazils, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Those are fire. Yeah, I got maybe four pairs of green shoes, if that. I don't need any more green shoes, so it's going to be a
pass. Two pairs are Kobe's. Yeah, two pairs of them. The greens are Kobe's.
Oh, yeah, I got Grinches. Yeah, I don't need no. I think I got a pair of Jordans that are green. The Celtic ones. Remember back in the days, they had the Celtic ones. It kind of had the patterns of the floor over in, I forgot the basketball.
Did the Travis Scott sixes count as green? Mm-hmm.
You know what? That's a Travis Scott. So I gotta give him a pass.
That's not green. That's not green.
That's like an army green. So I
guess. I mean, I think we could give. I mean, that's kind of like this. Isn't this kind of the same green? Or am I wrong? I don't have those Travis Scotts. So.
Yeah, that's a little bit. That might be a little bit more darker. Like that's probably forest. Mm-hmm. That's like a forest, maybe. Yeah.
Who ate the McDonald's yesterday? Anyone indulge in pretending to be Travis Scott's mouth yesterday, or
I wanted to, but I ate too much food, so I'm like, let me calm it down yesterday.
Yeah.
So today,
I can't do McDonald's every week like that. I mean, I'm already growing like crazy right now. This pandemic has got me eating all types of terrible stuff.
I'm too old for that. It'll go right through me. It won't sit right if I eat that stuff.
I feel you.
And if I do, it has to be like no fries.
Pain, you got a lot of kicks. You just have a lot of sneakers, Payne.
He's got a shoe galleria. He's
I know.
Fucking,
well,
you know
got,
what I mean? Like
the bat cave, he calls it.
Yeah,
like,
for sure, for sure.
Who?
Payne. You seen Payne 82's collection?
No.
Oh, you gotta follow him, dude. You gotta check his stuff out, dude.
Yeah, wait a minute, Payne 82.
He's like
the,
He's like the phone posit version of
I spoke to him that day with you.
Yeah, yeah. You I thought so. Yeah, he came in here, he showed all of his phone posits.
Bro,
anything made out of phone posits. Oh, we got DS Kicks in here. If you want
to hammer,
I'll post the link real quickly.
Yo, he has this one foam I would love to have.
Yeah, the Beijing joints, right?
Yes, that foam.
Yeah,
oh
yeah, you were. I remember it like yesterday.
Facts.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah, I remember that.
I would love to have that, man.
Yeah, he's got some nice stuff. He does.
Well, these are ruined. Oh man.
Holy shit.
Yeah, the paint job. I mean, I can repaint them, but I think I'm going to wear them to work, man. These are going to be my work shoes. Man.
Yeah, that's the cut the grass shoe right there.
Facts. I'm over it.
Yeah, that's yard work. That's yard work right there.
I tried to repaint them last night. I was like, I'm done, man.
That's so bad. That's yard work.
You ever mess with the split tongues? The gel light threes, they have that split tongue.
Yeah, I think I have a pair right over here somewhere.
Mm.
They have that paisley. They have that paisley type deal.
Yeah, I used to have more pairs. I used to have the earlier Ronnie Five joints. The Restock, I have all the sneakers linked in the description, Savage, for your convenience.
You have to have the other one.
Description.
This has
those are hard with the bandana.
Yeah.
It's that bandana P right there.
See, I mean, y'all taking them.
I used to have so many shoes, and I sold a lot, and I didn't really buy or collect for like almost a decade. And before that decade, I sold a whole bunch of shoes because we had our son, and you know what I mean? We needed to change everything around, down payment on a car, all this stuff. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So I sold a bulk of it, a whole bunch of Dunks, a whole bunch of Jordans, all kinds of stuff. Those are badass.
That's why I was telling Dale in the past. I was like, there's so many times I had so much authentic to the point, like it was like the guy, like this wall, it was like just straight off, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, you know what, let me just change certain things around. And I still got things, of course, like these authentics, I mean, whatever, but man, it's just been a lot of stuff that's changed, like, you know.
I sold like 5 pairs of Jordans this week. That's I don't wear them, the market's high. I'm selling them. I'm at a point now where like I don't need to have as many shoes as I have.
Facts.
It's a little crazy. And you know what? Everyone that owns hundreds of sneakers, we all are going to sell our shoes one day.
You're living in
a fantasy world if you think you're not. One day you're going to say, you know what? I've got too many kicks. I need to fall back. And you're going to sell them shits. So why not sell while the market's high? This is something to think about. Especially you look at someone like Mayer. Why wouldn't you? You know what I mean? We got more people coming up in here.
Yeah, Perm, you saw my story yesterday. You saw what I was trying to say yesterday, Perm. I think it's still on there on my Instagram. Yeah, I'm like, shoot, I'm a fair guy with my stuff, man.
Yeah.
What's up, everyone?
The Bat Cave.
The Bat Cave is in the building.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sir, I'm finna do actually review on those phone posits that I want, man, but it's only the replica, man. I can't get those authentic, man.
Yo, Kane, I have a request, man. If I stream on Halloween, I want you to cam up as Batman, bro. If you have a Batman costume, bro.
That'd be dope.
Don't judge me. I know it's weird, but whatever. I don't care. Oh, you showing up.
I got to get it. I got to get a Batman costume.
Yeah,
get a
Batman mask or something. I will literally
fall. Yes, sir.
Jeter Lowe's?
I love those Jeters.
Hey, GA, what phone pods are you talking about? You got replica, bro.
The Beijing ones. The one that has the Asian print all over it, man. It's the one.
Oh, you talking about the
10s? Yeah, I really, really, man. Those foams. If I can get my hands on those one time in my life.
I call them Sue Young.
those cool grays are crazy too, man.
That's
now we're breaking out the cool grays. I love it.
How much were they? I know they're arm and leg.
How much were what? These?
Yeah.
I can't reveal that, bro.
Oh God, man. Well, I gotta.
You have to hit me my DM.
And I dig it. The cool grays. I wish they need to bring the cool grays. Your boy show, man, Jason Tatum show, because them things are looking
beautiful. My man pulling out heat back there.
Facts, man.
Yeah, he's got a lot of heat, this dude.
Now he's gonna have me doing some stuff myself. Okay.
Wait. Keep those alive. Pick one right now. We going with Pantones.
I got cool those too. I got a lace swap in mine though.
Cool grays or Pantones? Leave it in the chat. Leave it in the comments if you're watching on the replay.
Cool grays.
I say cool grays cool for me because it's more easier to wear.
Yeah,
lace swap.
You know, it's like when you get older, it's like the shoes you got start copping. It's like, are you going to wear them more every day? You see what I'm saying? Like me, I do wear my stuff. But after a while, it's like, you want something like, okay, I'm going to wear? Or, and that's a cool grace for facts.
My man's going in.
Yeah, he's showing his collection. I love it.
He just called you out with that phone, Payne. Oh, shit.
Oh, maybe having a speaking battle in a minute.
Low key, huh? Dell started something. What'd you start, Dells?
Dell started something.
Mm-hmm.
This ain't the outlet here.
That was a clean, man.
So you called me out with the phones?
Well, I
got I was just kidding. Dooms? Are those the mocha? The mocha? The mocha? Yeah.
Ugh. Man, I want those. Still got my little.
Look at that insole though.
That's that oldie.
Who remember these bad boys, man?
Oh, the mellow?
The mellows.
Still holding up, man. About 15, what? This is 2005, yeah. So it's about 15 years. Still holding up, man. I actually rocked this about a few weeks ago, man.
Rajon Rondo.
My phone to charge for a minute. I got a cam off. I'm staying in, but I just got to plug my phone in. Damn, those are gems too. What are those? Those are the Rondo joints, or who were?
Yeah, this is Rondo's actual shoe, size 13 for him.
Yeah, what was that? Christmas time or?
Yeah, it's the Christmas joints.
Okay.
Christmas. Yep.
I remember watching that game.
Yeah,
He never wore this. This was a standby for him.
But he wore something similar, no?
He wore something similar, but not this colorway. He wore the one perfect pair. Got both pairs, game worn and the standby.
The one he wore didn't have that logo, right, on the tongue or something.
No, it had the RR on it for Rajon Rondo.
Okay.
You know.
Jeez, man, you got fucking everything, bro. I love it, man.
I ain't got everything, dude. I'm trying to get on your level.
Ah, nah, man. You killed me on foams, though, bro. And you know I love foam posits.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Definitely. I know that. That's my lane, though, bro. It's the only lane I could be in and separate myself from everybody else.
Those are the Shacks. That's the Brick City Shacks, if I'm not mistaken, right?
Yeah, man. I missed the pair to get the yellow one, the yellow and black one, the Minions.
Is that the Brick City joints or is that a different colorway?
Some Dons.
I didn't see the name on it.
Yeah, those are the Brick City ones. And then look at him showing them twos. Woo! Shout out to Calvin who hopped in here, showed kicks off, bounced out. He just wanted to handle his business. I appreciate that, man. Anyone want to cam up?
Oh, the man gone already?
Yeah, anyone want to cam up, show some sneakers?
Okay.
Nah, he just came in here on the humble trying to show some shoes.
He's about that life.
Yeah.
I was like, all right. I was like, let me bring a little some all authentics. You know how I do. I'm a fair guy. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, this guy Gucci got me laughing, bro. He said, Payne got everything but a t-shirt.
That's Gucci really crazy.
I've been seeing him out there, man. Salute to him, man.
For real. But yeah.
Shout
man.
Out to everyone watching. I love it. I love it, man. Make sure if you haven't hit the thumbs up button, please do so. We run in almost an hour and a half live.
These are Supreme.
Those are nice.
Supreme Air Force One Seamless.
Those are gorgeous. What's the star? What's the story behind that one? Anything?
That's the Supreme. The Supreme.
Oh, Supreme. Okay.
Yeah. Yep.
I was half listening. I got my son with me right now. He's got me jumping all up on my head right now, trying to put me in a chokehold, wrestling moves. He's going crazy.
If y'all don't know where I'm from,
Motor City, the D, right?
Yes, sir.
Oh, I gotta take this puppy outside. Chill out, man.
Crazy, man. These right here, man. These gonna stay with me till I die, bro. History, my guy. Those are nice as hell too. Dang, man, you making me, you shitting on me all goddamn day on the shoes, ain't you?
This can be something different, man. You know.
Yeah, definitely facts, man. My ex wife stole this pair, so I had to go on. At that time, I was looking.
Here you go, big perm.
Some foam. What are those foam? Foam dunks or foam? What are those foam Air Force Ones?
This the SB Air Force Twos. The penny.
Okay, yeah. Okay, I know the Supreme did one too. Supreme did a little Air Force Two thing, I think, with the dunks.
Yeah,
like some brown ones. I've seen some brown ones.
This not foam material. I wish it was. Oh.
Okay.
He got foam everything, man.
Facts.
Here we go again. The Tupacs. Gum Soul. It's my man, Big Pern.
Oh, there you go.
Tiffany's, right?
Yes, yeah, sir. Those jumped up, dude. Those jumped up. Yeah, those jumped up. The highs weren't as sought after or valuable for a minute. All of a sudden, of course, like everything else, Dunk, they jumped up.
How much are those worth now?
I paid $100. I paid $100 for these.
Honestly, I've been seeing them, like, if we're just gonna go by the StockX thing, upwards of like $600-$700, dude.
Really?
Wow. Yeah. I had an opportunity when they were like $250. I could have got them at $250, and I was just like, no, they'll be around.
That's what I jumped. Let me show these, my boys.
Hey, Dez, I know you talk about GOAT and everything like that. But if it wasn't for GOAT, I was able to get these bad boys, man. I'm not going to even flex. I was trying to get the black ones of these bros.
Yeah, but I'm not I think you're misunderstanding what I'm saying. I'm not shitting on GOAT. I'm just saying if you're buying popular sneakers that are being replicated like crazy, you got to be careful because you could have a boutique just selling it for you know what I'm saying? For like...
Yeah, especially now. It used to be a time. No, don't get me wrong. Yeah. It used to be a time
Come here, boy.
Those are nice. Those are real nice. I like that. That's definitely gonna be my last fives. That's the last pair of fives I want to get.
That's a good way to close it out with those. Just that's your last five right now, right? If you got all the necessities.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, you're right though, Dells, because there used to be a time. Yeah, if you was quick, you know what I'm saying. But now. They got everything made before it even comes out sometimes.
Like you buy a pair of Pumas or something off GOAT, like that's smart because you get it for a good deal. But when you buying,
I ain't gonna even flex. Not even the Pumas are safe anymore, bro.
Yeah, but I mean I don't know, man. How much are they selling Pumas for on that market? Do you know?
Yeah, around like 65, 70.
Yeah, but that's how much they cost in real life. You know what I mean? Like in real life at the retailers.
Yeah, that's
True. When you're going and you're trying to buy, for example, like a pair of Cheech and Chong Nike SBs, you know, that's when you're flirting with danger. Because there's a big loss if you got yourself a Fugazi. They ain't a big loss if you get yourself a Fugazi of some Pumas because they ain't worth much to begin with, you know? They got to bring those pennies back.
Facts.
Yeah.
There's some Pumas.
Yeah, have me bringing some stuff out.
Pull it out. Check it out.
Where you get those?
These?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay, the Bobito is saying, yeah.
But where do you get those?
These are badass.
I got the Bobito.
He has so many. He has a few. Yeah, he has a few.
I got the Pro Ked low tops. The I call them the Cinnamon Toast Crunches. I still have those. Y'all going digging in, showing all types of stuff.
You know what I'm saying?
Dog, those are fire. Yo, they were on sale last month, those foam posits, for freaking like, I think like $89.99, which was crazy to me.
Oh, these Memphis Tigers?
Yeah.
Yeah, I got them for 130 at Snipes.
There we go. Mm. Those are fire, yet. Those ready to die joints. I like those.
Bro, yeah.
Thanks to you.
That's a nice collab. That's definitely a nice collab.
For real. Thanks to you. That's how I was able to get these, man, on time, man. Because these, like, I don't know how much they are now, but last time I checked, they went to like 400, bro.
They're pretty expensive, man.
I'm like, no, I'm good, man.
Those foams are crazy, dude. This guy and his foams, he got them all, man. Yo, you got the Asteroids? I remember. I want to see those if you got those.
The Asteroids? Yeah, nice. Hell yeah, I got them. Oh, I got a crazy lace swap with them too, bro.
I want to see those. I haven't seen those in a long time. Oh, yeah, lace swap is money on those.
A fade is crazy how it fades into the different colors. That's dope.
You know, that shoe grew on me. I'm not going to lie. When I first seen them, I was like, nope. But now I really like them a lot.
You know, I picked these over the Gamma Blues, bro. Because, you know, these came out the day before the Gammas.
Mm-hmm. See, I remember that, too. Like, I got those Gammas. I still have them, actually. And those went on sale, too, if I'm not mistaken. They didn't really have much hype to them. But now I really like them.
Do you regret not getting these instead of the Gammas?
No, I'm happy with my purchase, but I really, I should have bought both of them. Let's just say, because at the time I was getting money, where I didn't have kids and I could just buy whatever and not be
at the time, the way my bank account was set up, I couldn't do both. I had to get these.
Yeah, the way my bank account was set up. He got his Kevin Hart on. Lakers won last night. Just talk NBA real quickly. You think it's downhill from here?
It's gonna go. It's gonna. I don't think Rockets are gonna roll over. Rockets are. Rockets been around too long. That Harden's not gonna let it go down.
I can't compete with my mans with the foams, but I can bring some other stuff out.
Ice cream alert! Those are dope. Man. Oh goodness! Breaking out more of them hyper. What are those hyperposites?
Yes, sir.
Oh, I love those. That shoe is a great sneaker. Never got the respect it deserved.
It didn't. It didn't, dude. That shoe.
The Liberty. I still have my Liberties. Love them. The Stoudemires I still got. They're amazing. Oh, you got both of them. Wow.
Yeah, man. Thanks. Yeah, man.
Those are gorgeous.
Able to get them online, thankfully. See, thanks to the Rona, I was gonna wear this to So
those are dope.
What else, man? I got, let me see what other heat we got out of here.
Hey, you gotta watch out for Miami. Miami's playing good team ball. I'll give them that.
Yeah. They are. Yeah. They won last night too, right?
Yep.
Yeah, they're done. They're done. They're on to the next.
Yeah.
Hey, here go another PE.
Even though Nike's gonna bring these back,
that wavy right there.
The big brother's out.
This the Ben Gordon. This Ben Gordon game worn. Game worn.
I like those too, man. You guys are showing nice stuff. Hey, do you own the Air Wavies?
Yeah, I got a pair of those.
Because those are foam posits.
Facts.
It's funny how Nike brought the wavies back and tried like selling it for a more premium price. Remember when they were only for like $79 when they first released? Or they may have even been lower. That was like the low income foam posit, you know what I'm saying? Like they charged real low money for it, which I thought was cool that they made it an affordable shoe. The foam posit wasn't as strong. It seemed soft. It didn't feel like they used the same material, like a polyurethane, like they usually use.
Yeah, it's real soft.
I don't even think it's the same material. Or maybe they mixed it with something else, kind of cut it. You know what I mean?
It doesn't really feel like it. It doesn't really feel like it, though.
Yeah, but it was a cool. It was a shoe that I thought, you know, it was an all right pair. But I think that because of it being so low of a price, people like at that time, they're like, hell no. You know,
this who's these Dales?
Oh, those are the lights.
Before the storm.
Well, what is?
before the storm, before it was so easy just to get an Air.
Tell me. You tell me.
Your boy Sharif. Atlanta Hawks.
Yeah, those are nice, bro. I had a pair. I had a pair of Amari Stoudemire PEs, actually, of those.
Oh, shit.
Oh, it's talking.
Mm-hmm.
The streets are talking. Shit.
Oh, I got some Stoudemire PEs too, bro. You probably got these.
I think it was the Knicks colorway. I don't remember. Mm. It was like, I got rid of them though.
You probably got these, don't you?
Clean.
What's that? Is that the black and purple joints?
Yeah, Phoenix Suns.
Yeah, I got those. I got rid of them though. I sold those.
My pair is a sample pair though.
Dope. Yep. Yeah, you got a lot. As I said, you got some nice sneakers, bro.
Oh, heck yeah. Way. Yeah, he killing mine. I'm like getting polished.
They go another.
Just showing sneakers. It's not a competition.
Oh, yeah. No, hell no. Hell no. Never that. Never that, bro.
Those are clean.
I mean, I really enjoy you guys coming up here showing sneakers. My audience, I know, does. So I thank you.
Here go a sleeper people don't really see too often.
I haven't seen those in a good minute. What are those, Ken Griffey's?
Nah, these the Megatrons. These the fly posits.
That's five. All air on the bottom, full 360.
Okay, because the bottom reminds me of,
Yeah, these the Calvin Johnsons.
Mm. Yeah, he had that whole crazy pack too, right? Didn't he come out with a pack that like it kind of was like,
this man got some collection.
It wasn't this one though. It was another shoe.
Yeah, because he had two different versions of his different collaborations. Excuse me.
Yep. Here go another Ben Gordon, y'all.
Fire.
Ben Gordon. Well, I call these the Nipsey posits right here.
Oh yeah.
These are sky posits. Shout out to Nipsey one time. Cookie Bell. What's up, man?
Cookie Bell.
All right. Who else we got? Got some Battlegrounds. Paul Pierce.
But these here, man. I really am in love with these bad boys. I ain't gonna flex.
Fire, those fire.
Yeah, those are clean.
I'm definitely waiting for the right time to bring these bad boys out. It's like when fall hits, that's what I'm going to do with the channel. I want to bring out more clothing stuff to show people different stuff to wear. You know what I mean? And for a cheaper price, too.
Get yourself some leather, silver leather pants. You know, some tight silver leather pants. And a
you know what? I see you trying to get with this, Dell. I'm gonna leave you alone right now, man.
Maybe get a little bandana, silver bandana. That'd be dope, bro.
I'm gonna leave you. I will leave you alone, Dell. I got jokes today. You got jokes.
Hey, listen, I gotta keep it entertaining in here. I'm trying to get some laughs in here.
Facts.
And if I crack on you, it means I like you. Always remember that.
Thank you. Somebody close my door.
That's true. Oh. Those ones I got those too.
I got those too.
Those are nice.
This is another model, super slept on. Such a dope pair of sneakers.
Very so.
Yo, even the 76er color, the metallic on that blue. Mm. And they have the glow on them.
Those
are nice.
Look at the metallic on that swoosh too. It pops so nice.
Never picked them up.
Oh, they're so nice. Love them.
Yes, sir. That was one of the best Nike basketball shoes in the world at the time. You go, Allen Houston joint.
Definitely my first questions ever, man. My very Allen first Houston. Questions. Respect my shine, my guy.
What colorway is that?
Respect my shine colorway, the white and black one that turns to gold if you rub it.
Oh, okay.
Oh, my bad. You couldn't see. My bad. I'm tripping. My vapor's in the way. But yeah, man, these are
foam domes.
definitely my my favorite ones. But the red toe's on the way, so we'll see how this one comes through. The quality.
Nice. Dale, you still what Dale's at?
Yeah, those are dope too, bro. Jesus.
Damn, Jier, you don't think about getting any drop fronts? Make life easier?
He's like, what?
He's I was saying to drop front box. I don't have drop fronts either. I enjoy keeping my
okay, box. Y'all. So here's my thing, Dales. Dale, where you at? You there, Dales?
Yep, I'm here.
All right, so this is what I was telling you about. Shugu.
Oh, yeah, you were telling me about that. I remember.
This is what I'm going to try to basically restore, bro. Because these parts is like almost
juice.
Like...
Go get some juice.
Go playoff eights? Oof.
Playoff eights?
Yeah, man. I love these, man, but I can't wear them no more.
Where's the separation at?
Hold on, let me see.
Old school J's. Let me see. I got J's too. Everybody think I just got phones. I got Jordans.
Hold up.
You got the suitcase ones?
I don't have a suitcase for them, though. That suitcase got stolen when I my shoes got broken.
Right apartment. Here? I'm tripping, bro.
Okay.
Which year is that eight?
Can't remember the exact year.
You just can't put too much in there because if you put too much and you squeeze it, it'll seep out on the side. So that's what you got to worry about. So the lighter, the better. Probably that stuff seems like less is more, like a little goes a long way. And mm-hmm. I would just make sure whatever area you're putting it on is probably like clean. Like, you know what I mean? There's nothing in there, no dust, no lint, and just clean that and probably just a little at a time. You know what I mean? And go from there and see how much works. So
that's what I'm going to do. Yeah. And this one here is just tearing up. Otherwise, if they ever do a retro, I would love for see this. What I love for them to bring back out, man. This and the Cherry 12s. Yeah, bro.
You're 100% on that. We need both of those back immediately.
Facts, man. But no,
I had the Cherry 12s, man. I regret trading them, man.
For real? You did?
I traded them a few years ago. This is when I was on my phone posit, like.
Nothing can stop you.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
I got you.
Look, I love phone so much. Look.
Those are nice.
Jordan 1 full foam? Full foam.
Yep.
That's crazy.
It's called anodized. The Jordan 1 anodized. They came out in 2009. So they just used the same blueprint they did with the Air Force One phone. They said if it'll work on the Air Force One, it'll work on the Jordan One. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Which makes sense. So had to add that to the collection. No. Pern, why you ain't showing nothing off, man? You got heat over there.
Yeah, I'm just chilling. I'm admiring your guys'. I like to watch too. So. I mean, guys have a whole bunch of different style of shoe, more basketball shoes, which is cool.
This is definitely one of to my opinion, I know LeBron dropped some dope All-Stars, but this, when it's all said and done, is going to be one of my more favorite All-Star LeBrons ever dropped.
Like, wait, what's that, the 17 or the 16?
Oh, these are going to be the 15s right here. This is going to be right before he went to 15s,
okay.
Cali. This is the reason why, with the theme behind and everything, the insole and everything. Probably can't see it, but you can see the pond, the beaches and all that, whatever, the trees. This is Hollywood. Mm-hmm. I mean, this is a dope. I don't know, bro. I just love this colorway, man.
The 10s are my favorite for LeBron's.
Oh, for real?
And I think the 10 lows, too, they look pretty dope, too. And I'm not like a low when it comes, like, I'm not a Jordan, like, 11 low. Like, I really don't like any of the lows. Yeah. But that's one of the lows I do like as far as basketball shoes turning into lows.
Was this is Jason Kidd PE right here too.
Jason Kidd's shoes.
Yeah.
Did he have the other shoe? It was almost like a sock shoe kind of. damn! If I see the picture, bro, I could point it right out to you, bro. And I forgot
I know
the
what
name.
Talking about. I know what you're talking about. I don't know the name of those though.
Nah, I remember it's some that at the time they were dropping so many shoes for different basketball players. Like everybody had their own sneakers.
Hey, I got a funny story with this shoe right here involving LeBron, right?
Mm.
I actually had a chance to meet LeBron. Like I saw him face to face, but I'm not a fan of his, so I didn't say anything to him. But the day I saw him, I had these on.
Mm-hmm.
I was working at Ford Field. That's where the Detroit Lions play at. Mm-hmm. And they had the March Madness there. And Davidson was in the championship. This was like 08 or 09, I think. I can't remember. Right. And LeBron was an invited guest of Steph Curry's. So I was on the floor doing security, and you had to have on all black shoes, which is why I wore this pair that day. And I'm looking down the tunnel, and I see an entourage of cats coming through, and it's LeBron. He got on all black, jewelry dripping. You know what I'm saying? Jesus, iced out Jesus piece, Rolex, diamond chain, bracelet, all that. He walked up to me or whatever, looked down at my feet, and we caught eyes, but I didn't nod my head at him. I ain't throwing the deuces. I ain't say nothing to him because, like I said, I'm not a fan of his, and I'm not starstruck. So I didn't say anything to him, but we caught eyes. He looked at me and seen these shoes on my feet, though, so he thought I probably was a fan of his and probably was shocked that I ain't say nothing to him. So I this always connects with that story with me. I never get rid of these because of that.
Wow, that's dope.
Yep.
Like I've never really, only person I got starstruck who I met was Allen Iverson. I met him when I was like, probably like in second grade, man. Second, third grade, bro. And
that's different. You're a kid then. Bro.
Yeah,
as an adult though, bro.
Yeah.
What would you do now if you was to meet him? You know what I'm saying?
To meet him now, it would be like, you know, what's up? Like, I mean, he always inspired me as a kid growing up. To LeBron, yeah, you know what I'm saying? He always inspired me as a kid. Even I don't know, because growing up, LeBron, I mean, Iverson was like the first to do a lot of things that a lot of players right now. I mean, you had Rodman, don't get me twisted, but Iverson, like I explained to people, made it cool to be yourself, to step out of the NBA norm. You know what I mean? Those are dopest. That team?
These the Agassiz.
You ain't playing no games, bro. Oh, let me pull out something of my dance.
And the way I feel about being starstruck, which is rarely ever, they've gotta have done something that I can connect to emotionally. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Like where they did something and it actually, like, I felt it in the heart. So like, there's not many people I'll get starstruck from.
It would be like, Iverson or Aaliyah. Like, that's the only, God rest their soul. Like, that would be the only two, like. Aaliyah, because that's my baby, bro. Like that's I would be
of course.
My baby, you know what I'm saying?
Hey, and she from the D too, nah. Let's not forget.
And that's a big thing too. Look, like this is a good example when it's someone from around your way too. Like some people will affect you in different ways too that are celebrities. My perfect example. Mm-hmm. I'm from Yonkers, right? Mm-hmm. So you've got DMX, Mary J. Blige, Locks. I see the Locks all the time. The Locks know who DJ Dells is. Like, you know, they I'm from that area, so they know who I am. You know what I'm saying?
You famous. Everybody know you.
So I see them. I never got starstruck in my life, but DMX, I haven't seen many times, and I was at their studio, Powerhouse Studio, and one day I was walking up the steps to go into, because downstairs is like this insurance company. You can actually see the building if you go to BET and watch the Rough Rider Chronicles. I recommend you watching it. It's really good. But yeah, when I seen DMX, I was so starstruck. I couldn't even look at him in the eye. I just gave him the pound, and I just was looking at all the ice on him. You know, at the time,
that's DMX.
Yeah, I'm like, holy shit, it's DMX. Like, you know, I finally.
Damn.
That's a celebrity.
I was so starstruck. I couldn't even really look at him in the face the first time I ever seen him, and then the second time it wasn't like that. You know, but. I think that people get starstruck when there's emotional value to whether it's music or sports.
Facts,
you know what I'm saying? Then you get that, you know.
But X is he has something that polarizing effect in hip hop.
Dude, X is such a, he's got such passion. You know what I'm saying? So I've always gratitude to him. You know, I like him as an artist.
Like, I probably would have been starstruck if I could have met Tupac.
If I could have
met Pac or Kobe, I probably would be starstruck.
Yeah, I mean, it all depends on. I mean, I've met Jay-Z and I wasn't even starstruck. I was like, yo, what up, Bo? You know, I was just like, whatever.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Like, because he never affected me. I never listened to his music and got goosebumps. Like, I got goosebumps like, yo, this dude's killing this shit right now. He's ripping this track to pieces, you know. Hard Knock Life Wave, you know, all that shit, you know. But, like, EX, like, I listen to X and I'd just be like, damn, this shit's so deep, you know. Some of the stuff you say, you know. So, Robert De Niro, I worked on a movie. I was an extra, but I was also featured in a scene. I was in Rikers Island with him for two days. Like going, I was literally in Rikers Island for like 12, 13, 14 hours a day. And I wasn't starstruck at all. And I love him. So that also means that me, and I did watch a lot of his movies and they moved me. You know what I mean? So that could be not only, that doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to get starstruck either, you know?
So. Yo, I met a lot of celebrities, man. I met I rap when I used to rap back in the day. I rapped for Be Legit, back in the day.
Uh-huh.
And Derek Coleman, you know Derek Coleman from the D2.
Yeah.
I met him. I met I freestyled with Badass. Rest in peace to Badass. When we used to have the summer jams in Detroit, downtown Detroit at Hart Plaza, he was here. It was him, Ray J. I remember running into Cole from Martin. And they was all cool, man. They was all cool as hell, man. Especially Badass, man. Like I said, I thought he was freestyling, but he didn't freestyle. He spit that verse to Wrong Idea when we were spitting.
Yeah, they always be doing that, man. The freestyles are written, you know. They're written rhymes, you know.
Yeah.
Oh boy, those are nice too, man. I haven't seen those in a minute.
Hey, I'm on the Dale. I'm on the Dale show, man. I got to represent real quick, man. I got to show some heat off.
Yeah, look, I got these right here. You were showing before.
You're in the stash, y'all.
Yeah, I'm in the stash.
You're in the stash.
See, I got
it's these. It's going to get wild, nah.
We'll see.
It's going to get wild. Man. Dale, stop it, bro. It's going to get wild when you in there. I already know. It was fun while it lasted with me.
Nah, get out of here. I don't got nothing really that amazing in this room. I'm gonna be honest with you.
I got those two there. Hey, Tien's is my favorite silhouette.
Yeah, it's a great shoe.
Nice. Hey, y'all, I don't know about y'all if I mess with Donovan Mitchell, but he has probably one of the best like Marvel shoes, like collabs. Don't get me wrong, like Jordan has their own thing, but at least you know what I'm saying? Got different, you know, ties to it, whatever, whatnot.
My joints.
Harden came out with a nice, I don't know if it was the Avengers or whatever, those series of superhero shoes. Did you see those ones?
Yeah.
There was a whole series of them.
Marvel?
There you go, Dale.
I think it might have been the Avengers. It was Avengers or something.
That's that
a whole bunch of, like, the Iron Man came out with the Iron Man ones. All kinds of different. I think it was Adidas that did the whole line. It was pretty dope.
This is Adidas right here.
Yeah, which one is that?
This is the symbiote.
Here, boo-boo, here. Come here.
Homeboy said if we end the stream, he'll go on. That's how much he hates the stream right now.
Get that hate out of your heart. Spread love. Spread love, not hate.
That's what I thought I'd seen it all. He said, I'll donate. I'm not chasing money like that. Trust me.
Hold up. Here. Let me bring some other stuff. You know how we do it.
Woo!
Hold up.
Here we go.
Those are legends right there.
All-Star? Okay, so look. We're going to do All-Star with Ron.
Look, I'll show some really hype. Some ponies. Who got ponies?
Not me.
He said, not me. I ain't got no pony.
Checks and jump mans over here.
Uh-huh.
One time for the GOAT.
Oh, here we go with some Reebok.
One time for the GOAT.
What you got one time for Reebok? Okay, you got the Reeboks. Okay, what you got?
Okay. One time for the... Hold on.
The ducks, the duck ones, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Dude, those sat at outlets. Those were just sitting at outlets, dude, with the fucking box top ripped off on the back wall. It's a ton of those, dude.
The closest, look, the closest I'm gonna get to the Grinch.
Jack, mm-hmm.
the closest I'm gonna get to the Grinch.
Why you say the closest you're gonna get to the Grinch for?
These ain't the Grinch Kobe's. These the Vinos.
But they're coming back, ain't they?
Yeah, they're coming back, but I already know it's probably gonna be impossible to get them.
So oh, don't do that. You gotta stay optimistic. You gotta stay optimistic.
That's what I'm saying. You gotta
keep
to.
The faith. Keep the faith.
Come on, Dale. I seen you pull out some bowls, Dale.
Yeah, yeah. See, but I mean,
Jack's classic.
Yes, sir.
Definitely one of the definitely cleanest All Stars that came out. One of the cleanest.
One of the best LeBrons ever.
Did y'all see the Yeezy inspired? Inspired.
Yeah, I got those. But I'll show you.
Nice. Those are legend right there too. Those are that whole pack. You got the whole pack, Dells?
I got all of them except the Kobe's, which I'm upset about still to this day.
No, oh, you ain't got these, Dells?
Nope. I'm about to block you. I'm blocking you now.
Yeah, that's what I felt that no one. Low key, I felt that no one was like, nope, get out of here.
Light flex, little light flex. Hey, no, but I want those KDs though.
Right here. Yeah. Some
jammies.
Space Jam. What's that? Oh, is that 09 or 16?
This is a new one.
Okay.
Talking about these on pain.
That's some cool, great. I mean, some true blues.
True blues.
No, mine is the. I got the Bo Jackson Yeezy inspired. That's what I was talking about.
Oh, okay. No, the Kyrie. Yeah,
this is right here. This is Yeezy inspired.
Y'all saw the Air Max that was that sold out for, Yeezy inspired. It was like the purple one.
Oh yeah, that color changed the game.
I got another shoe Yeezy inspired too. These right here.
I might get those perm. I'm not even lying, bro. I might figure a way to get those. I want to get those and the N7 Air Maxes. Those are the clean.
Panda Dunk Lows.
Those are nice.
Dale shut me down. Now I got to stop.
Come on. Who are you kidding? You just showed a crazy amount of stuff, bro.
Yeah. Right, samples and PEs and shit.
Woo.
Did you ever get the peanut butter ones? How do you feel about that?
Little thing, the peanut butter jelly. They were fun, but not fun.
That drip that they had on the swoosh.
Love these.
I love when Nike plays around with the swoosh. I love when they play around with the swoosh, you know?
This was a fun one right here, but this shoe is so uncomfortable putting on. It's like the worst. Damn, y'all these also here. A lot of nice sneakers.
These here are definitely, I always tell my subscribers like to wear the shoes and all that. But these are like man cave sneakers right here, and I got the sevens. I'm gonna keep these like non.
Yeah, those are really not. Those are really slept on, and they went on sale.
Yeah,
I'm kind of stupid. I didn't buy. Well, I'm not stupid. I'm trying to save my money. That's really what it is.
Yeah, I mean, it is what it is.
Nothing wrong with that.
Now, Troy, I put links in the description box, my friend. If you're trying to get them, look in the description. All them restocks are there, man.
I definitely would double up on these. Like, I'll get,
if you're
like,
just
my
walking
size.
In, please hit the thumbs up button. You're breaking my heart. We showing so much stuff here.
Facts.
Show some love. Some you got a dollar.
We ain't done yet, y'all.
Leave that in my way. Super Chat Cash App.
Coins. People are opening up their collections. Hit that thumbs up, man.
My favorite basketball, my childhood basketball player ever, Penny.
Yeah, those are cool.
For the Olympics, 1996 Olympics.
GA, if you're gonna have them set up like that, you need some drop fronts. Could you imagine if that was all drop fronts right there?
Dude, oh, yeah. you see my collection is the same thing. It's all boxes. I got maybe five drop fronts just for like glue shoes. I have no box.
Mm-hmm.
I like the box, man. I like seeing the boxes.
Hey, original gray toes.
Oh, those are nice.
Who's remember these bad boys, man? Who remember these bad boys, man? These LeBrons. Air Max.
Back to the Future joints?
Hell yeah, bro. These
are. I need those, man. What size shoe you wear?
Size 9.
Damn it. But
they slept on, bro. They still, you can go on eBay right now and they probably can get
those fire deals.
Some premium? Is those premium cross?
That's the premium joints?
Those are nice. Those are nice.
Is that Pinnacle? Those are Pinnacles?
Yep.
Those are nice.
And those started off like at $400. I think like
400. Yeah, I was gonna say
one of those.
Retail was $400, man. And then, hey, look, and then some went to the outlets and it was $200.
Oh,
okay. Yeah. I paid, I had a 20% off code when I bought these, you know. I know they hit the outlets, though, but.
Yeah, they get out. Like I said, it was 200. 200 at the outlet.
I really like them, though, so, you know.
Damn.
Sometimes you buy just because you like, you don't give a damn about that price tag. You know what I mean?
I think when those came out, people were just really after numbers and colorways, after the numbers. You know?
Yeah.
So those kind of came out at a weird time.
If they released them now, they would sell out instantly.
Oh, for sure.
Which one of these? Well,
remember these?
The pinnacle joints.
We'll remember these?
Talk to us.
Russell Westbrook Christmas, Jordan 28s.
Oh, yeah. Word? Those go all the way up, huh? Those go high all the way up.
Like, yeah,
is that the ones?
Word. I remember those. Mm-hmm. I was thinking about those the other day. Like, I was in those type of shoes the other day, those Jordans. Damn, okay, you brought them right there to life to me. All right. These, yo. I don't know. What do y'all think about the All-Stars these years, man? Like,
I like the sneaker. I want to see the movie first, though. My heart's not invested in that shoe.
Oh, that Monster. Those are the Monstar ones?
Yeah. Hell
see,
yeah.
Oh, yeah. Isn't there another one? There's another color of that, isn't there?
Yeah, Swag Hammer. That's like $800. Fuck at that shit.
I think Chilltown might have those. I'm not sure.
Yo, for real?
Some fucking Monstar ones, yeah, that were dope. That didn't look like that.
Those are nice.
What is that, iridescent toe? Iridescent toe on the toe?
That's a currency one, isn't it?
Yep.
Those fire.
Clean as hell.
The box is crazy on them, too.
Hell
it's like,
yeah.
It's supposed to represent his car.
Oh, shit.
And, if you watch Currency on the Sneaker Rabbit, he's been on this channel before. I just want him to be on a live. When he's on the show, he's showing this car that the box is. So
Currency Jones.
Search DJ Dell's Currency. You'll see him on the channel, you'll see the car that this shoe's inspired by. He's sitting on it.
Yeah, he's a heavy car. He's a big car.
What up, kid?
This is the best Jordan 8 to me right here.
Oh, I have those right over here. Those are dope.
The quality, bro. The quality is
sick. Yeah, they're really nice. Really, really nice.
The leather smell too, yo. Insane.
The quality on this shoe was fantastic, and you can still get
definitely. It. I'm kind of disappointed with the new Jordan coming out. This year was really really nice. At least you could wear these, you know what I'm saying, as casual.
Hey, so is Jordan doing some 35s?
Yeah, man. He has the fragments, and they have the Zions coming out.
I'll pull
out.
Up the image, guys. You guys, tell
yeah,
me
those fragments look crazy. It looks crazy.
What do you
out of 35?
Yeah, those look crazy.
Like, it has hits of the 12. I can see where the 12 inspiration comes from, but
yeah,
and then where the 34 comes from. I don't know, man.
Nah.
Maybe I can see more colorways, bro. But this year's
that collar, really nice. I like the way the collar's looking in the front toe.
Mm-hmm.
But that stuff in the middle, I mean, obviously super tech.
Those are nice. So Shacknosis.
The Olive 9.
Little Shacknosis vibe, no? Little bit?
There you go. Okay, let's see. There you go. You were doing it for a second. Yeah.
That's
yeah,
why I'm doing it.
Yeah.
Shacknosis vibe a little bit?
Yeah.
I see that.
Not bad. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But I think they're cool looking. I like how it's leather, too. You notice it's got actual leather on it, guys, right?
Look at that. Yeah, leather. Like synthetics with the fucking raw materials. Yeah.
Pretty cool, man. Look, I got a patent leather and blue in the back. I'm not mad at him.
Hey, this is my first custom right here.
Oh, you colored in. Nice.
Yep.
I like that, man. I like that.
The alternate Sharpie red foam posit.
The pain specials.
Yes, sir.
Back is like,
I need another pair, though, so I can have it OG.
Y'all see these? I remember these bad boys.
Is that Kyrie?
Oh yeah, yes, I love those.
You know what?
How many did you get?
Ones are the best ones to me, man.
He said that's the best what?
The Kyrie ones is the best to me.
Oh, I'll show you some Kyrie ones. Man. Hold up.
I love those. those, man. The Venus Fly Traps.
Venus Fly Traps, yes, sir.
Yeah, those are great. I got some Nike IDs I did on the Kyrie one. I did one inspired by the Yankees. I did one inspired by BB-8, you know, the robot BB-8 from Star Wars. Yeah, I like those shoes.
You got me bringing out some shit for today. Damn, Payne, you got me bringing out some stuff today. You talking about these bad boys here?
Woo! Yo. Yo. Oh, I need those. What day was the pool out? What's that?
This was, I came around the cut.
This is that Bling, the Bling Air Force One Premium that released this year.
I love when Air Force One does a premium, dude. When they do premium,
they came with these little gems, but I'm not wearing them with the gems. But they came with these gems. But
okay, so that's the recent one then. No wonder if you would have had those on it, I would know. Yeah, those ones. Not so, even one gem. Mm-hmm. Not even one. I mean, a lot of them on there is kind of busy, but maybe one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, maybe the swoosh on one of them.
Yeah, that swoosh for sure.
Yeah, so sets it off. But the shoe was so nice. I had a 20% off coupon. But they're so picky on what you could use it on. So I was like, I want some fresh new Jordans, Air Force Ones, you know? Jordans.
Facts.
Fucking
shit. How y'all like these Air Force Ones right here?
Mm. Oh, those are tight. That print?
Yeah.
These will come back out eventually, these Kobe's. Mark my word.
Those are sixes, right?
Yeah. That's the Kobe 6, okay. 3D Hollywood joints. 3D.
Dales, you got
too much. Do you have the glasses? That's right. Those that I didn't.
I did a review back in the days. It's funny. You see, me and my dog, we both are wearing glasses. It's pretty funny. Check out
and the dog.
Yeah. Just search for it.
No, I'm gonna look that one. I'm gonna look that one up for sure.
When those are sick, Payne.
Like a Christmas vibe.
Yeah, I like those, dude.
Appreciate it. Appreciate it, man. Let me see what else I got over here for y'all, man.
I gotta charge my phone for a little bit since you guys are going ham. I gotta plug these forces. Guys, I love it though. If y'all are hanging out, hang out, bro.
The DMP ones, huh? Those are the DMP ones.
These are Air Forces, perm.
No, they were labeled on Foot Locker as the DMP ones because it's like that black and gold.
For real?
They were labeled, yeah, those are a recent drop. So when I seen them in pictures, I was like, oh, I want them. And then I kind of seen them in the stores. I thought they were going to be a little bit more premium because they had that name behind them. And I was just like, oh, you know, it's kind of, you know. So, but they are dope. If they had a black bottom for me, I would have copped them instantly, no matter what the materials were.
Facts. I dig it. I haven't rocked these yet. I'm definitely going to wear these when the fall hits.
Yeah, that color blocking is dope like that. That's a good color blocking.
Facts. They got. Oh, let me bring out some Jordan 1 Lows, man. Let me show some.
What is that? Is that a golf shoe? What kind of Nike is that?
With this?
Oh yeah. What is that? I thought it had spikes on the bottom for a second. I was tripping. Oh, it does. It has some like fucking grit. Some.
No, these are runners.
Oh, it's Safari.
Yeah, the Safari joint.
I like the way they did that side panel with that embossed swoosh right there. That's pretty dope.
Thanks. Oh, let me show you this one, man. It's a recent pickup I got. It's got like a Jordan 3, Jordan 4 type of vibe to it. It's a flight.
Damn, what is that on the collar? Is that fucking chrome? Or what is that upper then? Oh, shit. That shit's hitting hard, dude.
Yeah, 3M. These the Flight Squad Quick Strike joints came out in 2014.
What's that upper around the collar? Is that a patent? Is that a patent leather that's hitting like that?
It's a synthetic. It ain't. You know what? Yeah, it's patent leather, but it feels soft though, like a soft patent, soft grain of patent leather. Real creasy, like real easy to crease.
You know, I had to do.
Got like a 3 feel, like. I'm not a fan of those, bro. I'm not gonna lie. I hate the Travis Scott ones.
There's something about these, man. It's like I like to wear. Sometimes I like to wear some comfortable clothing. So sometimes with Travis Scott's, I can.
Yeah,
just wear
that's
some,
super.
Like,
yeah, you could just throw that on, dude. I know exactly what you're saying.
Let me ask you.
That's super cash.
Do you, do you actually like that shoe, or is it was it hype? Like, keep it a buck.
I actually like the shoe. Like, I knew I actually like the shoe. Actually, the color blocking, I can wear the shoe anytime. Yeah. You know, I can throw it on and just boom, I'm good to go. There's some Jordan 1s lows now. I can wear it compared to much as this one. And even this is Travis Scott's. That's why, like I said, I explained in my videos. That's why with the Off-White 5s, that's what it's meant for, to actually put them on and go outside, show people, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's to me. We have, like, now, Dior's, okay, that's different. It's Dior's, so it's not, I feel you. What are those, Michigan's?
32s.
Ooh, dang. Okay, he ain't playing games at all today, bro.
Doggy got some things, man. Facts. He got some things, bro.
Facts.
I'm telling you, man. This guy got things, bro.
Little something, yeah, man.
Did anyone want to cam up? Feel free. We still got a couple of slots. The link is somewhere in the chat. You want to show off your kicks? Show off your kicks.
Let me see.
I'm just enjoying watching you guys.
Yeah, same here.
I mean, I showed a bunch. I'm taking a little break watching, and I'll come back in.
I need to charge. I need to charge my phone too.
Yeah, that StreamYard or Streamlabs, when you on your phone, drains it like a motherfucker.
Oh yeah, bro. My phone's crying to me right now.
Is it still breakfast time, man? Who wants some oatmeal? All
right.
That was a sick kid.
I got one pair of Fear Gods, and I like it because it did the little homage to the air raids, the ones with the straps, the lower ones.
Oh, that one, yeah.
That's why I kind of like the air raids back in the day. So,
did y'all see the ones PJ Tucker got, man? That sample, that red toe, like a Carmine almost.
Let me show y'all the mess in my room before I show you these sneakers. What we doing? So this is what we do, though. I love it, though.
I got to get to the charger myself, man.
A whole mess. What we doing?
Yo, that's wild, bro. How many kicks you got, bro?
It kind of does pop. It looks good. I mean, you know what I mean? As a sneakerhead, sneaker lover, like, to see that, you're like, you know.
Facts.
Hey, yeah, anyone want to cam up? We got a few slots. Anyone want to show off your sneakers? Let's do it, man.
But you know, one of the big reasons why I stopped doing just the OG boxes is because I was moving around a lot.
Facts. No, I understand.
I was moving around a lot.
Boxes get damaged.
Damaged. And then bugs was hiding in them boxes too, though, man. That's another thing. Too.
Exactly.
And you know what? It's a space saver too. Let's get real. You know what I mean?
Facts.
Yeah.
You do save space. Those, the suede on those are really nice.
Bananas. That's
super sleeper. I think it's still available too on Reebok side and Finish and Foot Locker if you're looking for them.
Yeah, those didn't sell out, but I don't know why they didn't sell. Those are dope right there, dude. I don't know why it was in sell out.
You know what the question is? Yeah. The questions are kind of like a Jordan 11 of Reebok to me.
Yeah.
Would y'all agree?
There you go.
That wrap around the toe is kind of like it.
But yeah. Well, I'm saying, as far as like, it's a cheat code too. Like, you can pull it out in any sneaker battle and it's damn near gonna win.
Yeah.
If you pull the right colorway out, that's for damn
sure. Yeah.
The only Iversons I had were the lower ones, and the insole. I had two pairs, and the insole had his face in it. I don't know if that's done on all the models, but it had his face in the insoles. I don't know which model that was.
The outsole or the insole?
The insole. Inside, you pull out the insole, and it's his face on the insole.
I don't know what shoe that is.
There was one that was a silver and black one. It was a silver and black one, and then I had, I think it was a red, something with red, maybe. But I had two pairs.
My favorite Iverson is the the question, the answer four, where it has his face in the bottom, and then it has survival of the fittest, only the strong survive, like from Mobb Deep. Mm-hmm. I love that. I love the black one, the black and white one, the white upper, nice tumbled leather, as a zip, it zips up. Really nice shoe.
My favorite, the red toe questions.
Yeah, those are fire, dude.
The ones that just came out.
My bad, y'all.
Which ones came out?
He's talking about the original, the pearlized ones.
Okay. Yeah, the original. the original with the leather.
But the ones that released Perma are really nice too.
Yeah, man. Yeah. I can't wait. This is on the way, and I need my Bubba Chucks, bro. I need to get my Bubba Chucks. I do not care. I gotta get them before 2021, man. I have to.
I've seen those in store. Not the Bubba, but the ones that just came out, the Iversons. Mm-hmm. The material. I was looking at the materials. That toe is not. It's not the way I used to remember it. That red toe, like kind of suede or nubuck.
It's not what
I used to remember on how it was. They had some other ones that had like a patent leather toe, like a citrus and a Carolina blue type one. The Carolina blues and the citrus. Those ones look nice. I was like, I'd rather have these ones than that red like suede.
The only reason why I'll get that because that like was the basically when I first like that was the first spike picture I ever saw fucking with Iverson a long way, man. We crossed Jordan in those questions. I was like, okay, this is my guy right here, man. This is my dude right here, man. Cause like I said to anybody, you know, that's my favorite player.
They had to outlaw that move because he did that to Jordan.
Oh yeah, facts. That's guaranteed. Guaranteed, bro. That was the dude right there. Like I said, Iverson just changed the game for everybody. Yeah, white boys rocking braids.
Yeah, who? Mm-hmm. Hold on, I gotta shout out someone real quickly. Shout out to my boy Jordan for the soup, the Cash App. Thank you so much, bro. I don't see you in here. I have a feeling he's just busy and he's just wanting to show love. But thank you, bro. Always appreciate you, man. My dude Jay.
That's what's up. Hey Dales, I got a pickup coming in from a very beloved sneaker YouTuber. I'm not gonna say who he is yet until I do my video. So y'all stay tuned for that.
I know who it is.
You know who it is?
who you've been trying to connect with, right?
Huh?
You were trying to connect with him a few months ago. You were DMing me, I was trying to help you. Is that who?
A sneaker YouTuber? No. I got one coming in from a sneaker YouTuber.
Oh, okay.
A very beloved sneaker YouTuber. Who you talking about a personality? He's not a YouTuber. I know who you're talking about, but no, not him.
Yeah, you had to correct me on that. You're right. I give you that. You're right.
Yeah, very beloved sneaker YouTuber.
Instagram personality, right?
Yeah, all that. Yeah. Shout out to him, though. Shout out to him.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hell yeah, man. Hey, Dales, whatever happened to Sneak Geeks, man? You know about him?
I think that he just got tired. I talked to him on the phone many years ago, and I think the problem with him was he just couldn't handle the heat that he was getting because he kept buying over at
Soul Land.
Yeah, nah, he was at somewhere else. He was at I forgot it. It's such a long time ago, but he was buying somewhere where the shoes were coming in questionable. And he just kept buying, you know. So people were giving him heat on it, you know what I'm saying? Because he had this one pair of Jordan 6s, and the R looked all crazy. You know, he just couldn't handle the drama, the internet drama, because he's an older guy, you know.
Yeah. And that was my guy, though, bro. Like I said, it was you, him, Franelations, Hess Kicks, Jumpman Bostic. That's all I was watching back in the day, bro.
I tried to explain to him. I go, dude, you didn't know they were questionable. You thought they were legit because it was a different time then. You know, it's not like now where everyone knows like a lot of these shoes are you know UAs. You know what I'm saying? Where and sometimes you don't even know if it's that. You don't know what anything is. Everything looks so good, but at that time it was so new and fresh. All he had to do was say, you know what? Oh, Air Randy it was. He goes, he couldn't. I suggest because I told him, I was out the dead soul there because I think that they're like, I can't trust them no more. You know what I'm saying? Because what happened was, I think with Soul Land, they were sending me good pairs and then they were sending BS to other people. Right. So when that happened, I had to stop them. I said, I can't mess with you no more because I can't do that to people. And then I literally told, there was videos I told people, stop going there. You know, stop going there. And that's all you got to do. But you don't have ESP. You can't see the future. You can't see what's going on in someone else's home and if they're what's going on. You can only see what you see through your own eyes. So if you start hearing the same thing over and over again, something's bad. If you keep rocking with them, that's going to make you look terrible. And he kept rocking with the Air Randy. And I think that's what really dismantled his situation. Because for one, he couldn't handle the heat. And for two, did people, a lot of people I think were watching because he had the early shoots, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But
yeah.
And another thing is he started investing in Bitcoin really early. And he's probably sitting on a lot of money, like a lot of money, because he was on Bitcoin before Bitcoin really blew up crazy.
And he cashed out at the right time too. Yeah.
And he was telling us to get involved with Bitcoin. A lot of people were laughing at him, like, "Yo, this guy's a weirdo. He's generating coin, digital currency." Like, people are like, "What the hell? Had he lost his mind?" And he's probably a millionaire, to be honest with you, right now.
Damn. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was my guy, man. I used to rock with him, man.
I mean, look, he was reviewing the shoes. I genuinely think he didn't know that there was some shady stuff going on. I really do believe that. But sometimes it's the way you handle things. But it's never, you can never say never. Maybe he'll come back.
You can come back from anything. You can come back from anything. If you messed up on a sneaker, all you got to say is, "I messed up." You know what I mean? I thought they were legit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, you can come back from shit like that. It's just, you know.
I mean,
and nowadays, people don't even care. People don't even care as long as you're like, "Hey, these are UAs. I got these from this. I got both. Like, sometimes I can't get this, so I really want to wear it on my feet. So I went somewhere else and got it." Like,
you're talking to me. I mean, for example,
I mean, I get it. Would I do it? I don't. And I don't judge other people from doing it. And I always preach, just don't push it on me, because I have, you know, like, I'm the kind of person, if I can't get it, on to the next. I'm on to the next.
Right.
There's so much stuff out there that I like and I'm going to like. It's just on to the next. But like, you can come back from that. People make mistakes, you know, so it's whatever.
That double E saying, these are stores that claim they were legit shoes, and then it was questionable. You know what I'm saying? It's like, at the time, people believed it. You know what I'm saying? The fakes back then and the replicas were so obvious, right?
Yeah.
It was so obvious. So you had people that were getting them from these sites, and then you had people that were blatantly saying, like Bullet RC and Tony D.
Was that Spider-Man?
Saying, "Yo, we got the super perfects. Those were the bootlegs." You know what I mean? They knew they were getting bootlegs. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So it was a difference when you went to these places. They claimed like they were legit shoes. All these spots that he's putting up. You know, but maybe he'll come back one day. Maybe he won't. But you know, I wish the best for everyone, man. I really do.
Yeah, for sure.
I got the Spider-Man's down here. The Spider-Man's down this way. You're down here.
Hey, so Dale's between
the Spider-Man phone posit. You got those, Blake? I mean, not Blake, Payne?
Yeah, I got those. You want to see them?
Yeah, I haven't seen those in a while.
These are nice, though. I ain't gonna lie, man. These are...
Now I'll give you some vitamins, okay? Put some clothes on, I'll give you some vitamins, all right? All right. Hold on, Dale's.
Yeah, these are definitely clean, man. I'm Chicago's. I had to get a pair.
My boy Charles sent me a super chat. Let me get on camera. He sent me a super chat and he said, "Yo, Dells, would you wear a Nike SB Low? What size, Chicago?" Of course, I'd love the Chicagos. Oh, those are sick. Those faux posits. I wear size 9 or 9.5 in SBs.
Hey, I couldn't decide on the laces, yo, so I just did both.
No, dude, that looks beautiful. I love it, man. And thank you, Charles, for the super chat. Thank you for being a Patreon member too, bro. Check out the new podcast, Charles. We're doing video now on the podcast now. All right, bro? Please.
Was that the Air Maxes?
Yeah, I love these, of course, man. Yeah, I love those, bro.
The only reason I passed on those, it's because I have some fours. I like fours, but the reason I passed on those is because that the same reason I didn't like the cause, they have that suede that goes all the way down to the midsole, all the way. And I was just like, I'm not a fan of that. That just kind of threw me off sometimes.
This guy called you Conrad Thompson. You probably don't know who Conrad Thompson is, but he's like this real famous podcaster in wrestling. Victor is calling you Conrad Thompson.
Calling who?
This dude, Conrad. Yeah, you look like him, Perm. You look Yeah, you do. You have the same beard as him, and you sound a little like him. Look him up, Conrad Thompson.
He sounds like a player. He sounds like a player.
He's pretty awesome. He's this very successful podcaster. He does a show with He does a show with I'm having a brain fart right now. Damn it to hell.
When I have my beard bigger, they say I look like some famous country singer from some famous country group. I forgot the name, though.
JR. You know, the guy JR. He looks like he does a podcast with JR, man. So, you know, very pot. Let's see. He says, I got you. 9.5. Okay. I need you to do a review on feet. Okay. Well, shit. If you
of want the to Chicago's? Hey, of the Chicago SB Lows?
I think so. This guy here is one of my best supporters. He sent me a pair of the Westbrook Super Soakers because he knows how much I love that.
Nice. And
I'm always thankful to have great supporters, especially
Hell Charles. Yeah, that's a good person, man. Dope,
Aloha,
Charles.
My friend. Yeah, man. He knows.
Hey, y'all know he's
from the island? He's from the island? Yeah. The big island?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Hey, dude.
From the big island?
Oh, those
y'all
are
know,
sick.
Hey, dude, you know about the samples, right?
No, tell me.
Okay, like, you know how you had, they call it, Final production samples where they had like the 999 code on the
aren't the production samples the tag is like slit, it's kind of like a half a tag or no?
No, it's still a regular tag. It's still a regular production tag. It just say nine, it's got like a bunch of the 999s in here. I don't know if y'all can see that. I didn't know that these was that. I ain't gonna be able to get it into like, but I was just looking at these joints, and these are final production samples with the 999 code in them.
Sick.
Like anybody could have a final production sample. Like you can get it from the store. You never know. They can be mixed up in there. And you'll never know that you got a sample. Like my what's the names is like that too. My Rio 10s. I got some Rio 10s. That's a final production sample.
Gucci crazy.
Yo, he got some things, man.
You do, bro. I'm like, bro, I can't even compete with this man no more. I'm done. I'm still
samples, PEs, samples, PEs.
I love it. I love it, man. You know what? You know what though? You know, y'all know how I get down. So y'all know what I show as it is. But the first I was showing all authentics. You know, I had to compete with y'all. You know what I mean?
Ain't no competition, man. It's just hey, this is genuine love.
Know, but for
it's
me, I don't like
genuine
you know,
love right here, y'all.
But for me, it's like
that's right. It's just us hanging out, man. We can't go out. We can't go party. We can't go anywhere. We're gonna hang out at the crib and show kicks and talk.
I love these, man. These are like to me. I fell in love with Off-White after this pair itself because this, like I said about the Travis Scotts, I can wear this anytime. You see what I'm saying? I can just put it on my feet, and I know I gotta look down at my feet like, oh man, my shoes is ruined. No,
well, they already come beat up though. They already come kind of beat up, like you know,
yeah.
Beat up.
I guess that's just me. Well, the older you get, it's like you just want to just enjoy life. You know what I'm saying? Don't get me twisted. I got some shoes. Yeah, that's clean now. Like, you know. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, it's good to have some type of shoes that, you know, you can wear and not worry about it. But let me show some other stuff. I got these bad boys. Oh, Dells. I'll talk to you offline about that. I don't know if
I talked to you about
these, you know what I'm saying? I don't know if y'all like these, but I think that the original ones look way better.
What the hell is that?
That's gonna be the Off-White 5s, what's coming out of the sales, man.
Oh, okay.
Like the White Fire Red version. Deconstructed.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. They keep having so many sneakers coming, I can't even keep up with these Off-White shit.
Facts.
I'm crazy. Be honest with you.
Yeah,
I understand, bro. Trust and believe. These came yesterday. These were supposed to have been here since like April. I ordered these in April. I got two pairs. I got these, and I got the Unite, the threes. So these came in yesterday.
He said you sweated bullets, GA. You got you. We working you out today. Pause.
Pause. Yeah, facts. Facts. My room is the hottest room in the house.
Over his room, doing all types, grabbing all types of kicks. I love it. I love it.
You already know, man.
But, hey, y'all, let's do this then. Let's do this, y'all. Let's all show off some gifted shoes. Shoes we had gifted to us.
Shit, that's a good question, bro.
That's easy. I got one right here too.
Sure. Let's check it out.
I'll go back to the sneaker room. I wish I had an outlet close by. My outlet is like being used by the computer and all types of stuff. But I'm going back.
I got 17% right now, man. I'm on the charger too.
Sometimes the price that some of my local friends sell me shoes,
mm-hmm.
I feel like it's a gift to what they're going for these days. So
that's what it was, a gift to me. That and my Unites.
I've got so many shoes I could show you guys. Oh, I'll show these first because this was recent.
Let's see.
Well, you had Big Pern. Let me see that gifted shoe. What you got, Dales?
So this Brad. I got from Charles. He mailed me these as a gift, and I love these so much because I'm a 90s guy, so like the Super Soaker was so crazy back in the days, and having the packaging and the shoe in general has like water.
That's fucking badass, dude.
This is an amazing gift. I think one of the only like actual like sneakerheads to gift me shoes. I've gotten tons of gifts from like brands. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Like these were a gift from Reebok, but I'll tell you, man, this is very special to me because it's from an actual viewer, which I consider family. He's part of the Patreon and all that too, so really special.
Does it matter who the gift's from? Is super dope.
It matters. I mean, to me, like getting it from someone who's actually a viewer of my show is amazing to me. It's like next level, you know.
Word.
I think that's more special to me than Jordan Brand mailing me something. I'm gonna be honest.
Word. Because that's their job. They're gonna do that anyway.
Exactly. This is love right here. You know what I'm saying? So you can't.
Yeah.
You can't even compete with that. That's like real.
Right here. These were a gift, and I just had talked about them.
Let me see. Those, you know what, Perm? You know I got the UA versions of those, and you know what's crazy? That Seth Fowler was reviewing them, right? Before they came, when they came out, and like the first ones, they're so comfortable. Like the Fear of God ones.
Yeah, the high ones.
Yes, man. You can wear them all day long. But those, my God. I had to get Keefy Lugs, bro. I'll show you what I'm talking about. These bad boys, man. I put these in there.
You got those gifted deals?
Yeah, this was straight from Jordan Brand.
Oh, those are nice.
That's a sample too, ain't it?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, the box looks like a sample box, right? That's a sample tag.
Wow.
It's company header. Yeah, this was from Jordan Brand. This was the last shoe Jordan Brand ever seeded me.
Wow. Lucky. Hey, this is the first gifted shoe I ever got from a company right here at SneakerCon.
Oh God.
Y'all so lucky. Y'all be getting gifts. I gotta buy mine.
Rejuvenator. Shout out to Rejuvenator. Rejuvenator gifted me these 2017 SneakerCon Atlanta.
That's nice. Okay,
look at this.
Okay.
Jordan Brand, first shoe ever gifted to me. But this wasn't from Jordan Brand. This is from a Jordan Brand employee that I cannot say who it is. And she just got love for me. She would tell me, yo, I'm gonna give you these, but this ain't from the brand. This is from me. So she used to hook me up with a lot of dope shoes, and this was one of them.
I'll show you my gifts, I guess.
Nice.
Yeah. Shout That's out love. To you. You know That's who you love. Are. She probably watches my videos still, so it's my home.
That's dope, bro. Hey, to get it from the source, bro, that's man.
Yo, I got Dornbecker 4 sent to me by this girl too, who worked for Jordan Brand. I remember that story, Dales. I was so mad I didn't get them because I'm such a comic book nerd. Like I love it, you know. And I was so bummed out. I was like, damn. Mm-hmm. And I was younger then, so I really showed my emotions, be like a little baby about shit. So I was ranting a little bit on Twitter, and she DM'd me. She's like, listen, I'm gonna do my best to get you a sample of these, but I can't get them to you for a month or two. And then what do you know? A week before Christmas, they came to my front door. I forgot all about them. Wow. I couldn't believe it.
That's love. Right,
this is another gift I got.
Wow, those are sick.
This came from my man Bane Kicks on Instagram, and he gave me a special insole in here too.
Oh, what's that?
Oh, the custom. That's the custom one, huh?
They say paying 82, and it's
PM. That's hard, bro. Oh, that's hard.
Facts, bro.
Yo, shout out to my dude Charles. Thank you, my friend. Again, he says Nike SB low fat tongue. Which fits better on your feet, 9 or 9.5? These are coming from the UK. 9.5 is fine. Whatever works, bro. I'm not a picky guy, bro.
And I was trying to buy these from him. He had a double up. I was trying to buy them from him.
Thank you again, bro.
And he just gave them to me. He just sent them to me. I just want to give them to you.
That's what's up, man.
So. Yeah, those SBs haven't released yet in the state. The ones your homie's talking about, those haven't released yet in the states. Those are still overseas.
He's got this guy Charles has an amazing sneaker collection. Mm-hmm. He does not play around. He's got like the briefcase.
Get on the cam up.
Oh, nice.
You should cam up, bro, if you want. Show some sneakers if you're free.
Another gift I got.
Here, say hi to everybody.
Hey,
right.
What's up? What's going on? If you want to cam up, feel free. Just click the link. You can use your phone. I got to check on my son.
Here it is. This is a gift I got from my man from China, man. Somehow. I don't know how I got it, but he sent these to me for free, bro. The good quality one, too.
Those UAs or the Authentics?
UAs, you already know me, man. I got to keep it a buck with y'all, man.
Okay. Hey, yeah, now look. The best gift I got. The best gift I ever got. Here, go out, baby. Go out. Close the door, baby. Close the door. All right. The best gift I ever got is a shoe that eluded me for 8 years. A grail, super grail.
Which one is that?
Galaxy?
Galaxy phone. Wifey got me these for Father's Day. This is the Father's Day gift.
See, that's my grail. It's going to be the LeBron 9 Galaxies, but I want the authentic because I don't know if y'all remember, they did at that time made LeBron fake LeBrons at that time. Like I have a pair of LeBron right now. I'll show you a perfect example, bro. Because they had them.
It's the best gift. It's the best gift I ever got right here. Father's Day.
Yeah, Fotis needs to come in here. Fotis is a young OG, dude. Fotis collection is crazy.
LeBron 9 O Spire.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I got a few shoes gifted to me though, man. But that's like my top three right there.
Yeah, nice. That's why I was asking. Does it matter who the who gifted it for you? My wife gifted me those, and she's not like a big old sneakerhead. She likes her Adidas runners and stuff like that, but she's not a sneakerhead.
I didn't even see what you had, bro. I didn't even see what you had.
It was the Fear God Air Raids, those low ones. It has the strap like the Air Raids. Yeah, those joints. I like about the Fear God series is I think he's the only designer that came in, high end designer designed his own like silhouette shoe with the Fear Gods. Like everybody, like Virgil and all these other people, they just took an already made silhouette and threw talking and little ideas on it. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So I think he's like one of the only ones. You know, Kanye, he wasn't really like a designer, high-end designer. You know what I mean? He was just an influencer that came and made the Kanye, whatever, you know, but he took pieces of shoes to put it into one. So I think the Lorenz guy is one of the ones that created his own Nike silhouette.
I like the storyline.
That's pretty dope. And he made him the ball in, actually, though.
Yeah.
And super comfortable and wearable.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. I wore him for the first time a couple months ago, man. Real comfortable.
I like his storyline. I was like, his background, what happened with him? You know what I'm saying?
He's a Chicago guy too, right? He's a Chicago guy.
Lorenzo?
Yeah, I think he's a Chicago guy.
No, he's from LA.
LA?
Yeah, I believe he's from LA.
Virgil's a Chicago guy though, right?
Virgil from Chicago and Don C. Yeah. And Don C.
Okay, Don C. Maybe that's who I'm thinking about is Don C.
Shout out to Fly Ming in the building. Yo, you know, Kanye West, he don't really design the show. I'm sure he just tells
what to do.
Yo, I wanted to look something like this.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's how it goes, you know? You know, I got gifted, too. I got gifted the Pirate Blacks from Chic Shoes.
Mm-hmm.
They gave me those for free. The Yeezy 350s. And I also got the Turtle Doves gifted to me by someone at Adidas who's no longer.
Bell's got $100,000 worth of gifted shoes. Yo, salute to that. I ain't mad at that.
I'll say I don't think that it's a big deal anymore because he don't work for Adidas, but Wex sent me the Adidas. I was like, holy shit. I told Wex, I like went on a little rant with like how whack shit is with Adidas. And I guess was like, yo. But that's my homeboy. Like, Wex is my guy. So
you told me that story.
Yeah.
He was like, jump on, Fotis.
You saw me. He was on vacation. He about to go on vacation. And yeah, you saw yeah, that. Yeah, and he just went off.
Because I was pissed off. I was like, "Yo, you know hip hop?" Because he does know hip hop. I was like, "Yo, it's crazy." Like I think of Run. I think of Adidas. I think of Run DMC. I think of, you know, not like mm-hmm. where things are so limited. Like, let the kids be able to live and buy the sneakers. Put them in the air. Let's put the Yeezys in the air and all that. Facts. And I was like, yo, I've been supporting Adidas for so many years on my channel. I go, I can't even get the first Yeezy that came out. And we had a conversation. But I never shared that story until he left Adidas because he didn't really want me talking about it. I'm sure he still doesn't want me to. But after it, I think it's a fun story to talk about because it just shows Facts. How, like he understood the game of hip-hop. Like, he understands it. He used to even DJ, you know what I mean? So, like, mm-hmm. he used to work with all the music videos with, like, Missy. Like, I don't think people understand. People look at Wax, they just think of Kanye West. But this dude is, like, a major piece for Adidas. Like, and for him to leave Adidas is crazy. Like, not him making the move, but for Adidas to, like, not, like offer him the, like, everything to stay was, like, it's just wild. You know what I mean? But maybe mm-hmm. he just didn't want to work there no more. But yeah, big dog. But, yeah. I got the first two Yeezy Adidas shoes to drop for free. Those were crazy gifts. I mean, I used to get dude, I have a box that's made out of part of the wood from the Barclays Center that they sent me, and it got Barclays Adidas Crazy 8s. I still have the box. I want to get rid of it, but I don't know who wants. I'm not going to throw it away, and I'm not giving it away because, shit, mm-hmm. I'm going to try to get some money for it. You know what I mean?
Like, that's dope.
For real.
Oh, I got something else crazy. I'll show you in a second. I got a camo for a second, though.
Yeah. He said he had me working, so yeah, I'm putting everything back up and everything now.
Told you. That was... Get the drop fronts. And then you can still, even when you get the drop fronts mm-hmm. and not put them that maybe high, you can that. Still have your, like, empty boxes, like, as a, like, around the drop fronts. You know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. as another layer around them, you could still use the empty boxes like that. You know what I mean? It just makes life easier. It just, you, I know you like to share your shoes and you probably go, you're doing a workout right now. You know what I mean? So it just makes facts. It easier to grab, put back, grab and put back. So
facts. This right here, this is one of the first Nike Air Max signs ever in existence.
Word.
I got this as a gift from a Foot Locker employee who said, we've had this at the store for over probably 20 years and we don't know what to do with it. So if you want, you can have it. This is all hard plastic and it's huge. It's sitting in this little hallway in my girl's room to our guest room. And
what do you think? Look at that.
This is all air units, guys.
What?
This is air units.
Oh, that's dope. That's dope right there.
Look at my hands and look how big this thing is. It's dang. All air units.
What is this? It's two pieces? It's two pieces?
It's one piece hand... of plexiglass here, and then it folds, and then it goes here, and then it goes here. So inside is a sheet of, it's like the size of a door.
Dude, that's fucking dope, dude. That should be up. You need to have that up.
Yeah.
Along with that foam, along with that big old foam, that big old chunk of foam you had. I'm the kind of dude that would fucking put that up somehow.
Yeah, well, I want to say that is for sale. But you're looking at that's like a $20,000 sign right there.
Yeah,
it was sold by Shoezeum for about that price, from my understanding.
That's what I have right here. A buddy of mine, see that right there? I don't know if you can see that right there. I got that from inside of a Foot Locker store from a buddy. That they had that in their store, just, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You know how they change stuff all the time? I was like, when you're ready to get rid of that, let me have that. Mm-hmm. And so if nobody claimed it, nobody claimed it, and I took it. And it just has a whole bunch of different sneakers on there.
Oh, we Fly wants to know what restocked. There was a bunch of Jordans that restocked. The Jordan UNC to Chicago, the Red Satins, some Air Jordan Mids restocked, the Biohacks restocked. There's links in the description if you want to try and go for it. You may be able to have some luck. I tried to organize it nice. So check all that out. And if anyone also is balling on, like, the super budget, there are these old school Adidas right here that's only on sale today for $44, and it ships worldwide. That's linked in the description box below, which is a pretty crazy deal for these. They got that bulky vibe, which is really
a Wave Runner vibes.
Yeah, definitely does. $44 effing dollars today. The extra discount is when you go to check out. So, Damn, this may be one of the longest streams in a long time here. We're going almost 3 hours. Holy shit. It's a damn telethon right here.
Yeah. Hey, Delzy's fellas, kids. I gotta check out though, man. Hey, I appreciate you having me on, Odell.
Yo, you always welcome. And anyone that got sneakers and good energy is welcome. And if you got some humor to it, that's even more of a plus. So always welcome to come through.
Oh yeah, right, you've fellas, already seen part of Otis.
All right, I'll probably still be in the chat, but I gotta get ready for work though, fellas.
Yeah, do your thing, bro.
You've seen Fotis' collection. He was on Team East, the young guy.
Yeah, he got
that had the Heinekens. Yeah, they had the skunk.
I know exactly who he is now. He had the dunks and took us out the game, right?
No, that was Primera. That was West Coast.
Okay.
That Fotis had the skunks.
Oh yeah, those are sick, the skunks. Man. Yeah.
Skunks are nice as hell too.
I could have probably bought a dozen pairs of the skunks back then when those released. It's crazy. I got one though. That's all I need, right?
Facts. You got one. Oh, you got a pair of skunks?
Yeah, I got skunks. Nice. I've got the. I showed you guys the Cheech and Chongs earlier.
Yeah, the Cheech and Chongs are dope.
Mm-hmm.
What's the skunks going for?
I don't even want to
imagine. The Cheech and Chongs are up there too, but skunks are probably a little bit more than those.
Really?
I'm not sure. A couple grand. Even used, probably a grand.
Wow.
Yeah.
But now they got those now up in China.
Yeah. Oh, across the water. What did they say?
Across the water. Mm-hmm. Across the water. I don't know if I want to even get them.
I don't know about that term because all shoes are from across the water.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
So, I mean, it's just like.
That is very true, but it just sounds funny how they.
Right.
I like how it sounds. You know what I mean?
Across the water.
But if you really think about it, it kind of doesn't make any sense, but it just sounds funny to me.
Yeah, I didn't get them on dry land. I got these on dry land, not across the water.
Yeah.
The mainland. These are the mainlands right here. I got these on the mainland.
Yeah. These were made in Detroit right here. Imagine that. Made in the USA Jordans or Nikes. I'm surprised they don't do like a limited release made in the USA, you know, something like that with Nike and Jordan. They just don't give a shit. They just like whatever.
Did you go after any McDonald's stuff?
No.
No.
I wanted the chicken nugget pillow, but it was $90. I thought it would be funny to have for my kids, you know, but I'm not giving them a $90 pillow. I'll spend $90 on something else for them before I have, you
know? Pillows for the whole family.
Yeah. I mean, but the pillow, it's a full size, like one of them.
It's a nugget. Pillows. It's a huge nugget.
So it's like, it's kind of funny to have in the house. And like everyone in my house has a pretty good sense of humor. Like we did, I tried pranking my daughters for their YouTube channel the other day where I had like a fake poop and my daughter keeps leaving her teddy bear on the ground. So like I put the fake poop on it and because I kept warning her, we got a puppy. The puppy's going to drop a deuce on your stuffed animal. The stuffed animal's been through hell. Like the dog already ripped one of the ears off. We had to sew it back on and like. Not even back on. We had to just sew it together. The teddy bear has literally one ear. It's a funny video. If you want to check it out, it's at the Dells, Delzy Sisters. Oh, this guy's here. Okay, Eric. Add to stream.
Oh, Fotis.
Here we go.
That's Fotis.
Yeah.
Yeah, what's up, my dudes?
What's up, man?
Fotis.
Yo, what up, Perm?
What's going on?
Nah, just chilling, you know, here. Just watching you guys.
Getting antsy, want to share some shoes. I know that feels.
Because you guys have been talking about like the gift and shit, so.
Yeah, show some kicks if you don't mind, please.
Yeah, so I'll just share like the, probably like my three favorite shoes that my fiance has gifted me over the years. So, so here they are. Here's the. So the first one. It's going to be Tiffany's.
Damn.
Woo! What a woman. She gave me those?
Yeah.
You didn't even need to pull those out in the battle either, huh?
No, facts. I didn't.
Jesus.
That's the date night shoe. Dude, if you would have pulled that for the date night shoe, it would have killed mine for sure. Yeah. Like, come on. Diamonds are a girl's best friend. Like, that's that.
It's crazy. Yeah, she actually gave me the highs first, and then she got me the lows.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so.
What was the knock on the highs? That the material wasn't as good as the lows?
Nah, yeah.
When I first seen the highs come out, yeah.
It wasn't good. The material wasn't good at all. And the shine, it doesn't have the shine like the OG does.
Yeah, and it's still like an $800 shoe right now, brand new.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
Like, if you wanted to get it, the highs, it's like, now they're good? Now the materials are good?
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
Hey, I was happy with my highs, man. I really love
them. Yeah, the
I
highs
like
are...
Highs. I like highs better than lows. And we're not talking about Bud here. And I just really was happy they made a high. Like, I was so, I love wearing those shoes. They're so
dope. That's a shoe. That's a shoe.
Give me my Uncle Dunkles and my MF Dooms, and I'll be A-okay with my Dunks, man. I just want my Uncle Dunkles. Someone stole those from me. That's why I want those crazy babies. Bro, I'm mad as hell. But I was looking all over them, and I was like, dude, there's no way my Uncle Dunkles. I don't know what happened to them, so bring them back out. I'm good to go. I'll go.
You know what was a real sleeper with SBs, I think still to this day, is the Motley Crue Dr. Feelgoods.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man. I have not seen those.
I have
those are definitely a sleeper.
I have them in my storage. Those are gorgeous.
I need the De La Souls, not the lows. I want the highs. The lows, I don't like the lows because the white, no offense around it. It's just like I know I'll get dirty with that thing within a day or so. With the insoles, how they are.
And of course, probably my second favorite. You guys were talking about it, so I have to pull it out.
Yeah, I know you know what are those going for?
Those are freaking clean, bro.
A couple of grand, right? For those, if you want those.
Man.
Yeah. Those are crazy. Really nice shoes, man.
Facts. Then they got the coughs too, the strawberry coughs over there now too, across the water.
With no box.
I don't like those strawberry coughs.
No, I don't like them either. They okay.
No, let me ask you guys a question.
Mm-hmm.
What's up? I see when I was doing my investigating for the UAs, I see on these sites were the strawberry coughs. Do you think most of the people that are showing these strawberry coughs got UAs?
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, me too. I think so too, bro.
Unless you're that certified in the community to get it, you know what I'm saying? Like you have, you know, Wade God, those type of guys, you know what I'm saying? Those people, mm-hmm. Like you're certified in the industry. Someone like me, hell no, bro. I'll tell you off the strip, the rib, UAs all day.
But are they even being? I mean, are they even being made by Nike?
Are they really made?
UA? They just saw an image and started making them. Are they being produced by Nike at all?
That's what they're doing, dude. I really think that's what they're doing, man.
What? I mean, because for example, like I just said, the reason why I said I would go and buy the Galaxy LeBron 9s because at that time they had like the LeBron 9s I just showed you, the Heat Home. Those are like UAs, and at that time they had the Galaxy 9s and the other one, the 11s too, the King's Pride and all of them. So like you have to really, like how you were saying, be very careful, because I'm not trying to get a UA version of that shoe. You see what I'm saying?
Well, the thing is, who wants to pay for a UA and it's not the legit shoe?
That's
throwing them all.
That's what I'm saying.
I mean, I like these shoes, right? I mean, I personally think they're pretty, they're fun looking pair to wear, you know?
I think the Skunk 6 better, though. I like the Skunk 6
better. They are better. No, that's not even something to question, but, I mean, these are just fun looking, you know what I'm
saying? Yeah, facts.
They made it like a berry kind of vibe in the red and,
I mean, I'm glad Dunks are getting their props. You know what I'm saying? It's just that for the people who's been in Dunks, it's like this new wave is kind of like, oh, finally, welcome to the party type of shit. You know?
Yeah. Tell me about it.
If I would have known, okay, like not gonna brag, but if I would have known that they were gonna, I always thought like, oh, I can get these again when I sold them back in the day. I was like, I'll be able to get it again. Nah, I was a bonehead move what I did. So.
You didn't know. Nobody didn't know.
Trust me, I'm real pissed off that I couldn't get more.
Because I have few Dunks right. I had few Dunks. I had like some. I had like Negro League Dunks, bro. Like I had the Rays and some of those, man. Like old school stuff, bro. That if I had kept, I don't know how much it would be right now on StockX or GOAT. But small there'd be fortune. History.
Otis has got a small fortune right there.
Yeah, he got some nice shoes, man.
All of a sudden.
Appreciate everyone that's cammed up, showed sneakers.
Since he mentioned.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, I want those, man. I would like to have those and my MF Dooms, Uncle Dunkles, and that'll be it.
Oh, yours are in phenomenal condition.
Fast.
Yeah, I've worn
mine them. Are like looking like such shit.
But see, you wear your shoes, Dez. That's the difference between you and these new sneaker tubers. They don't wear their shoes. So it's like with them, they just get the shoes to show everybody, but they don't wear their shoes. That's why I try to show everybody on my Instagram what shoes I wear that day. Yeah. Like, what's up?
I need Dooms.
Yes, those, I want those so bad, bro.
Yo, that's so crazy. I'm shocked they didn't put out a low when they were doing all the low tops and making them high, and all the high tops making them low. I'm shocked they never, you know, did some with that.
What, the MF Doom?
Yeah.
Yeah. Could you imagine if they did a low of that?
Facts.
I mean, they should have, you know.
They might though. Who knows? I mean, you know, especially what's going on now with the craze. Might as well take advantage of it. And you know that's MF Dooms.
Which dunks are kind of like my favorite, and I have a few of them. Is when they do the like I call it just the crossover with like Jordan. They'll use a classic Jordan color.
Put it on.
You know what I mean? Things like that.
I think I know what you're talking about. I think
like see, so. These are the cement. These are the cement.
You know I had mean? That. I had that. You know what's crazy, Prime?
So I like all of them when they do it like that.
I had that. You know what's crazy, Prime? I had that one, and then my first trucking company, Prime, I got fired. I had to leave those shoes in the truck because my brother came out from New York, and he picked me up from New York and took me back down to Atlanta. So I had only so much shit, and I know exactly what you're talking about. There were Lowe's, and he had the tongue of the eights, like that fuzzy tongue. I know exactly what you're talking about, bro. I remember them things, man.
This one is like the cement. It's just it's a regular dunk, but it just has the cement color.
No, mine's was that's the name. It was exactly the same time. Regular like dunk, but it had like the tongue of the eight on there with the fuzzy part, but it had like the Nike thing. And in the back part, it had like the design, whatever, of the playoff eights, like how they did it. I know what you're talking about. Old school. That's what I'm saying, bro. Like this whole dunk crave stuff. Like I'm glad people are onto it, but I had those. But the damn fucking missile got yellowed out. The bumblebees. Throw those bad boys out. They got yellowed out. Cause my dumb ass put in the washing machine.
Yo, so I think my finish line orders aren't really rocking, man. Because I just paid quickly through PayPal, didn't log in, and I don't see any confirmation yet.
And then when
I go in my PayPal account, it's not saying anything. I just got the emails from PayPal, you know, that I submitted an order. So I probably didn't get it, unfortunately. Oh well.
Facts. That's all we can say. Oh well, right? You know what I'm saying?
Oh well. What else am I supposed to do?
Yeah.
Finally, they actually loosened up. Because I was worried about these because they were so tight. Because last year, I ended up getting 9.5. Because I thought they were going to be the same sizing problems last year. So I got to update people on this. Let them know you can stay true to size if you're a narrow foot. But wide footers, you're screwed.
I found this hoodie at Ross, like, the other day.
Mm-hmm.
And then I had to cop because
oh, you also saw the stuff I got from eBay. Perm, Doug, you saw the stuff I got for eBay, right? This shirt? This Nipsey shirt?
Yeah, I like that. I left a comment on your...
Oh yeah, you sure did. This guy, he's back now. I'm gonna go on eBay. He actually has like the hoodie versions. He has a Supreme with Rick and Morty. I'm gonna show off some stuff when I
come up. That's a come up. That's a come up, Fotis. that's basically $100 hoodie.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You're spending $100. You're gonna put out $100 to pay for it. What material are those forces?
Canvas.
Yeah.
Got Troublemaker.
Is it canvas or denim?
Canvas.
Okay.
Got that over here. That can go good with something. Shout out to my boy Chaotic Kicks. He making his own stuff too, but I gotta get a large. It's too damn tight on me. Well, I'm getting fat. That's what the problem is. I'm getting fat. So let me quit BSing myself.
Yeah, I would love if they brought those Wu-Tang dunks out, man. Brought them back. They should.
That would be. I think they are. I think they're coming back out.
Yeah, I know. Amazing. I mean, I love Wu-Tang. You know, it's like that's life right there, man. That's soundtrack music right there.
They're probably gonna get fucked up on price though, since Travis wore the actual Wu-Tangs yesterday.
See Dubs.
Yeah.
Did the little character wear the shadows or switch into the shadows in the commercial? I heard that a couple of times.
I think so. I did a video yesterday where we watched we did a reaction to the commercial.
Uh-huh.
Check out that. Were you in that stream yesterday, Perm? I thought I felt like
no. You may maybe I don't know for how long.
Check out that stream yesterday. It was funny. We went through Twitter feeds and seen what people were doing, reacting to memes.
So if he wore the shadows, I think so. The kids in the hall.
Yeah, those you were in there for a little bit. Did a reaction to the commercial.
I was there. No, but was he wearing shadows? Was the little character wearing shadows?
I feel like he was.
Does that count as Travis wearing shadows, and that means those are going to go up?
Maybe. He was wearing the Union 4, so that's automatically going to go to hell up.
Well, people were saying too that Kylie Jenner was a big part of them going up.
Yeah, because she's the one who rocked the MF Dooms. Like, she's actually the one who started the whole.
Yeah, because she bought craze. You know, she bought a lot of them off Franulation, from my understanding.
Yeah, she did.
You know, a lot of people hate on her, whatever, but she's a Cali girl, skater, the environment that she's in. You know what I mean? Dunks, all vans. You know, so. I can't hate on that factor too much. I can't question her, like, if she always liked skate shoes. You know what I mean? Like, I can't question that. You know, so.
I don't know. I think people just like to hate on that family, but I like all of the Kardashians.
They're cool.
And Dennis,
you know? They don't really. I think it's a lot of the women who do, because, like, no disrespect, they couldn't capitalize off that shit. Like, the shit they're doing for free. While they're doing what they're doing, they're getting meals. You see what I'm saying?
I follow Kim Kardashian, you know. I mean, she's to me, she's fire, too.
Don't sleep on her movement. Don't sleep on her movement.
Exactly. She's getting people out of prison.
That's what I'm saying.
Like, she's doing a lot of dope stuff for people, man. Like,
you know? I can't hate on somebody like that. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, a lot of women, they did what she did for free.
Mm-hmm. Oh, those yeah. Oh, with the bong, bong, bong. I know what you're saying now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I'm just like, listen, she just capitalized and she's helping everybody get out, doing what she got to do. Hey, you can't hate on someone for that. At least she's not being, and you know who else was who's very smart, a lot of people sleep on? Mm-hmm. No, Paris Hilton. A lot of people think Paris Hilton was on some dumb stuff. Nah, she's very, very, very smart. I just read something about her the other day. She said she acted like that growing up with her and Kim because of what she's been through.
Mm-hmm.
But she wasn't dumb though. They just told her, you know, the fathers or people just told her she better calm that down or she's gonna lose like basically her rights to the hotels. Oh, that's nice. That's nice. That's nice. You see the one that LeBron's coming out with? The soldiers, the black and pink.
Yeah.
Those are nice. I like those. I want to get them, but see, I got the witness. I got these here. Oh, I'll show you. The fours. So the witness fours? Yeah, the witness fours. I got these bad boys here. Cause I couldn't get the red carpet, but now the red carpet on Ghost like only $100. Yeah, I got those too.
Yeah, I'm about to get those red carpets off the goat, probably.
Yeah, I was like, man. So now they're on $100. I like, I might swap out. I don't know yet, you know.
On those Jordan or those LeBrons right there, are vicious. That patent leather.
Yeah, facts. Big facts. Big facts. A lot of people slip on it. See, you know what it is? I think a lot of people are going to miss LeBron when he retires. You know what I'm saying? And then it's like, I don't know. I don't know. I respect all the players, man. All their greatness. I'm not going to be one of those people and wait till something happens to them. And I'm like, oh, I'm a big fan. Like, the only biggest fan I'm not the biggest fan of is going to be Steph Curry. Like, he's cool, but...
He messed up the game for me coming at watching it at a high school level and a travel ball schedule with my son. Mm-hmm. I just seen the game transform from wanting to go hard to the hole to freaking just jacking up threes. You know what I mean? Like, he kind of made the game softer.
Yeah.
From what I saw.
That's my guy. But I like everyone's opinion.
I like his excitement for the game. I like that part of the game, but like as people want to mimic him, that whole everybody wants to just jack up threes, you know.
Yeah.
Coming from an era of Jordan getting into the paint, into the hole, and taking those fouls, you know, it's just like.
Right.
You never kind of changed it up. That's just my experience from what I've seen on the little travel ball circuit, you know. So it's changing now. It's changing now. So
yeah. Back there. Mm-hmm. I gotta get into the super chat real quick. So my boy Fly Ming is asking about the Hardens. His pair, it's feeling a bit tight on his foot. Now I'm having the same issue on my pair too. On the right, let me see if I got the shoe somewhere here.
What's the material? Is it all synthetic?
Nah, it's a nice leather, but right here, it's like really uncomfortable on one of the feet. I think it's on this foot, on the right.
It was like that. It was like that for my for whatchamacallit, just for my Dons. You might have to unloosen them. Like really,
I loosened that shit out. Look at them, man. They loosen like look at them coming out of the damn thing.
They're wide.
Yeah, as wide as F's, man. And right here, it's uncomfortable. It's like scraping onto my foot. And I don't have a fat foot. Like, my foot is just meat and skin. You know what I'm saying? So it's not it's not like that. But yeah, bro, I'm having that issue, man. Thank you so much for the super chat. Appreciate you, brother.
That's hey, awesome. Fellas,
I'm at the body here.
You take care, big dog. It was
good. Bodis, all right, Bodis.
I appreciate you guys.
Appreciate you.
We 3 hours in. Holy shit. Y'all are chilling.
Facts. Y'all are chilling.
Shit, I got to make my kids lunch right now, but if you guys are hanging out, I could just do it while
I have to probably do some stuff. My son's going to be done with his little Zoom classwork. Yeah, he's doing Zoom classwork, and we got to go get some stuff done. So I had banker's hours this morning, so that's why I was chilling.
Cool. Yeah, that's my whole thing. That's why I keep going in and off camera. They got the Zoom classes, you know?
Yeah.
Facts. Yeah, me, I'm going to get me some food and relax. And
yeah, I appreciate you guys, man. Thanks, Del. Thanks for letting me chill.
Oh, no,
man.
Thank you for hanging out, man.
I'll see you guys.
You too, big dog.
Yep. All right.
All right. That was dope, man.
Facts.
I wanted to show you guys this photo I just found real quick before we go. It should be in this feed. Oh, okay. Here. Look, so this is another look. Is it going to show? What the hell? Oh, so look, we got another colorway of these shoes. What do you think of them? We've seen that one colorway, and now
they're
going to
go. They're going to go, man. They're going to go.
I think these look pretty good. Kind of like a Nerf colorway a little bit.
Yep.
Right?
They're going to go, man. I'm gonna have to get my hands on those, that colorway.
I think they look real good. Mm-hmm. So they're doing good, Jordan Brand, with this new model. And we'll probably do a whole video on these eventually. I like to dig up a lot of images.
You know what they look like? The Dub Zeros mixed with the 34s mixed with the 12s. All those put together.
With a little Shaq Gnosis on top. Just facts. A little Shaq Gnosis on top.
Big facts.
Yeah, I think they're pretty cool, man. But, yeah, man, if you guys have anything, last call on the chats. If you got anything to speak on, let us know. If not, we're gonna bounce some. We're 3 hours deep in here. Thank you everyone that came up and streamed. Thank you to everyone that donated here, sent me some paper. I appreciate it. If you watch on the playback, you want to show love, we've been here 3 hours to entertain you. That's where it's at right there on the Cash App. Thank you to my boy Jordan again for the Cash App. Thank you to everyone on the Super Chats. You know, we're doing it. I'm putting a lot of time in this. This is some full-time stuff right here. So, just show that love. Even if you ain't got the paper, just thumbs up the video. That's free. It's free content. Pick up my Sneaker Addict t-shirts. You will love them. You'll get tons of compliments. You'll find a lot of wealth in your life. It's a good luck t-shirt, too. There's some of the designs. That's linked below.
Facts.
Kick, thank you so much for coming through, bro.
Man, thank you so much for letting me in. Thank you so much, bro.
All right,
for real.
And we'll catch you. We'll catch you soon, GA. And thank you all, guys, once again for coming through. Watch yesterday's video. If you're just hanging out, watch yesterday's video. Watch Travis Scott video, people. Again, a kick out of it because we're cracking jokes, roasting, and it's a lot of fun. So watch yesterday's video. We also did a real versus fake off the Kobe 5s. Guys, be careful with these Kobe 5s because the UAs look like crazy good. They look just like the legit. So be careful with those. Watch all the vids. Support what I do. Turn notifications on. Subscribe if you're new. And will I stream later tonight? I don't think so. Maybe. You just never know if there's something worth talking about. But you never know here. All right? It's always spur of the moment. Much love. We out.